Welcome to the BoshNRoll channel. I'm your host, Brian Koval. Before we get started, make sure to hit those like and subscribe buttons. If you want to see me play your favorite deck or your spicy brew on the channel, I take donation deck lists. I'll do a deck tech, play a full Magic Online League, and help tune your list. If that sounds good, check out my contact info. It's in the video description below. Now let's go play some Magic.
Welcome back to the BoshNRoll channel. Today we're playing some cEDH, that is Competitive Elder Dragon Highlander or Competitive Commander. And this league is sponsored by Patreon subscriber Akia. If you want to sponsor decks yourself or get involved in the conversation via the channel Discord, check out the Patreon. It's in the video description below. So what is cEDH and what is the point of it? Here is the official Command Zone guide for the Command Zone at Magic Fest. This is a tool that helps you ascribe a power level, a numerical power level to your decks so you know how to have a fun game against strangers. Like, hey, my deck's a 6, mine 2, cool, we're going to have a fair and balanced game. The problem is that this is deeply subjective despite the best efforts to describe what each power level is doing. And the commander card pool is vast. Like, it's the legacy slash vintage card pool for the most part. Like, you could do crazy stuff, or you could have, you know, Squirrel Tribal, and everything in between. The game is not fun if I think my deck's a 5, and so do you, but yours is actually a 7. Or I think my deck's a 7, but it's actually a 5. And the power levels matter a lot for a fun game experience. So what cEDH does is just breaks the dial off at 11, and we all agree we're going to play the most powerful busted, we are going to try to win the game decks. And that skips this whole power level conversation, skips the feel bad of your deck's actually a 7, I thought we were playing at 5, and we agree that if you win, you win. Awesome, shuffle up next game. So that's the appeal of cEDH. My deck today is designed by the Hermit of the East Tree at TheHermitDruid on Twitter and TikTok. He is one of the voices of cEDH, one of the public-facing people, always memeing, always happy to engage in conversation. If you have questions about the format, check him out. He designed this Ishai, Ojutai Dragonspeaker, and Jeska, Thrice Reborn, quote-unquote, Delver deck, based on what Legacy Delver is trying to do. So let's check out this list. The commanders, as I described, are Jeska, Thrice Reborn, and Ishai, Ojutai Dragonspeaker. So Ishai is a 4-mana 1-1. Whenever an opponent casts a spell, put a +1 counter on it, and you have 3 opponents, so this is going to get real big real fast. Jeska has 2 abilities. One of them is choose target creature until your next turn, triple the damage it would deal. So remember, in EDH, if a commander does 21 combat damage to a player, they lose, no matter what their life total is. You get 6 counters on this, it's a 7-7, triple the damage, you have some dead players real quick. Jeska's second ability is minus X, she deals X to each of up to 3 targets. cEDH is full of hate bears, like Thalia, Guardian of Thraben, and Aven Mind Sensor, and all sorts of things like that. Picking off 3 of them across the table, or 3 flying blockers so your Ishai can start crunching through, is the other half of what Jeska does. This is a really smart pairing. The rest of the deck is built to just protect the queen. Try to get Ojutai big and strong. This deck is full of aggressive threats. We have hate bears of our own, like Grand Abolisher and Hullbreacher and Aven Mind Sensor, and the rest of the deck's full of fast mana and cheap counter spells. You can Pact of Negation, Force of Wills in here, Force of Negation, Dovin's Veto, Delay, Fierce Guardianship. That's a sweet one. Commander exclusive. If you control a commander, you can play this spell without playing its casting cost. I'm always impressed that this card exists as a primarily Legacy player. Like, this is so messed up. On top of this aggressive beatdown plan, like while your opponent's dealing with this giant monster, the deck also has multiple combo lines. So we saw Hullbreacher already when I was running down the hate bears. Paired with the Hullbreacher is Timetwister, Wheel of Fortune, Wheel of Misfortune, and Windfall. So at any point you could flash in a surprise, I have 7 cards, you all have nothing, and I have 21 treasures to work with. Like, that's something that exists in the deck. This is also an Underworld Breach deck. This combo piece is here. There is a Brain Freeze in the deck to go off with. If you're not familiar with this combo from Legacy or Vintage, it's you Brain Freeze yourself, exile 3 cards, Brain Freeze yourself again, you Brain Freeze yourself Building Storm each time till basically your whole deck's in the graveyard, then you start Brain Freezing opponents, and then nobody has a deck. and that's a combo that exists in this deck. There is Gamble and Enlightened Tutor and Muddle the Mixture to find the breach when you're ready for it. It is pretty scary what this deck's capable of. Hullbreacher is a messed up magic card, and while you're beating down with your giant monsters, if they put the shields down, if they answer that, think they're okay, you could just flash in Hullbreacher, untap, Timetwister, and the game ends in a different way. This is extremely powerful stuff inside a scary aggressive shell. This is a super cool deck. If you've seen me play Legacy Delver or seen anyone play Legacy Delver, check out my channel for Legacy videos, by the way. There's a lot of them. This is totally my plan. Just get one creature on the board, protect it until opponents are dead. My guests for today, my enemies, my opponents, are PleasantKenobi, Zach Allen, and Callahan the Mind Sculptor. They all have their own content that they make. Their links are all going to be in the video description below. They're all going to introduce themselves when we get into the game as well. But here are their Twitter links. Check them out. They're all awesome. Now let's go play some cEDH. Welcome back to the BoshNRoll channel. Today I have an exciting EDH pod. It's competitive EDH, cEDH. This was requested by a Patreon subscriber, Akia, who wanted to see some more cEDH on the channel after my last league. And we're going to go around the table in turn order, introduce ourselves, and I believe PleasantKenobi has won the die roll.
Hello, yes, I am Vince, also known as PleasantKenobi on the internet. I have won the die roll. I am the greatest beard in esports entertainment. I make content over on YouTube and on Twitch, and I tweet far too much. You can also find me on Instagram. I make a lot of magic content, Legacy, Modern, EDH, and a lot of just stuff around the game, probably too much. Today I'm playing Selvala, the green-white one, the one that makes mana and draws cards. And I'm playing a deck that was given to me by a patron. One of my patrons called Dong Lord, so big shout out. Big respect to the Lord of Dong. And yeah, it's half-elf combo with some typical elf stuff you would recognize from the Legacy variant of elves. Some Umbral Mantle combos that I probably should have figured out before I started. And then some Staxy parts, things like Hate Bears and D&T things. Things like Spheres of Resistance and Thalias and such.
So is Dong Lord's title up for contestation? Like, can anyone just show up and be like, no, I don't think so? And
I don't.
And I'm what does that sure contest look like?
I mean, I'd imagine it's like jousting, but I don't think it is like a title like that. I think it's more of a username, if we're honest about it.
Okay. All right.
You mean that's not like a role I can get in your Discord server?
Well, I'd have to offer it to Dong Lord for being the OG, the one, like the original Lord of Dong, you know?
I'm not from a country that has lords, but you can have more than one, right?
You can, but also lords in the UK are primarily hereditary, I think.
And so, you
can be made lord because recently some big donated to the Tory party. Sorry, I've got political with like less than a minute in, and other people haven't intro'd. Someone donated money to the Tory party and got made a lord, and everyone was like, "Wow, this is suspicious."
That's not
meant to be how it works.
I get Facebook ads all the time that are like, "I can become a lord in Scotland by owning like 3 square inches of land or something." Is that true?
Oh right. Yeah. I think there are like titles that you get with land. Yeah.
All right. And I'll take it.
Lord BoshNRoll.
Yeah. Put it right on the resume. Speaking of lords, Zach, introduce yourself.
Yep. All right. So you might have seen my first turn there. I had a pretty explosive start with that sick Genstone Cavern. But my name is Zach Allen. I'm a player on the SCG Tour. I'm actually, I think, the longest running number one player just because of the leaderboard getting paused during COVID.
Yeah, you've held that title for over a year now. That's impressive.
Yeah, it's hard to hold the title for that long. It's, you know, we're getting closer to 2 years now.
That record's going to stand forever.
Yeah, continued excellence. It's really tough to get it long.
What's the turn of phrase? Wrong man in the right place can make all the difference.
There you go. Yep. But yeah, I play a lot of, high-end events. I play GPs, SCG events. I've qualified for their Players' Championship twice. And now we're playing some cEDH because this format's sweet, and I am playing Breya. And it's basically just Breya two-card combos. I found a bunch of different two-card combos that essentially win the game with Breya, and I'm trying to put them together. And I'm just trying to be degenerate because I like degenerate artifact decks, which I know Bosh likes as well, right?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Many of my biggest finishes are with Mox Opal in the deck. I won a GP with Urza, won Vintage Champs with Paradoxical Outcome. I've done a lot of damage to the modern community with KCI when I could do that. So sure. I respect a Mox Opal for sure.
That's fair. I'm mostly actually known for playing blue decks, but Breya is blue, so this plays.
Yeah, count it.
Yeah, it's sans green. It works.
Yep.
This is not a blue card, though.
Yikes. All right.
That is offensive as hell.
Oh, that's fine. Let it happen.
Unfortunately, I have to pass on that.
Even right. Played around days. All right. While Zach draws his deck, Callahan, introduce yourself.
Yeah. My name's Callahan. I'm from the Mind Sculptors on YouTube and wherever you can find podcasts at. We make primarily CEDH content. We're going to start branching out doing other stuff eventually. I am playing the deck that I am probably most known for in the community, which is Lavinia Omen Pool. It is playing Lavinia and Omen Machine to try and control the game and lock people out and, you know, eventually win with some big payoffs. We used to play Knowledge Pool, but then I had to idiot-proof the deck because enough people... I've seen them play this and they would go for the wrong line. And I was like, okay, well, clearly this is not like helpful enough. So I just took out the one that's really easy to lose with and kept the one that's good.
Fair enough. And you all know me. It's my channel, BoshNRoll. I'm here playing Ishai and Jeska Thrice Reborn. This deck was designed by TheHermitDruid on Twitter and TikTok. He is one of the biggest voices of the format, and he modeled this deck after Legacy Delver. This is basically a Protect the Queen strategy. You get Ishai into play, and when your opponents cast spells, it gets bigger, and with three opponents, it's going to get big real quick, and then you just start clapping people for general damage.
Yeah.
And it's got Jeska as backup. If there's any hate bears or blockers or any little shitters in the way, Jeska can clear them out. I have not actually played this deck before because I tried to join a couple queues during the week, just some Magic Online queues. And even though I said CEDH in the description, people still conceded before any games were played when they saw my generals. So...
Well, that's because people see Ishai and Jeska and they're like, oh, you're going to one-shot me.
Yeah, you're talking about killing things that are in the way. Isn't Jeska zero of tripling the damage of Ishai also quite relevant?
Yeah, that also matters. It's not irrelevant.
Don't worry about it, guys. Don't worry about it.
Don't worry.
I haven't followed much of the CEDH discourse for quite some time. Is this pairing way better than value Merfolk 3-drop, or 2-drop, sorry? And whatever people used to play alongside that? Is this better?
Thrasios Timna? No, it's actually pretty good. Thrasios Timna is still, like, the premier, pairing for these.
It's the good stuff decks, then, right?
A lot of people play, like... did I pass?
No, it's my turn.
Okay, and we're on your end stuff. Okay, on your end. I about panicked and thought I like went on cruise control and just passed through my turn.
Yeah, anything's possible. So speaking of cruise control, I just tried to cast a 4-drop thinking it cost 2, and the camera saw it. You guys didn't, but I will own up to it to the viewers. I've literally thought that this card cost 2 mana the entire time it's existed, but apparently it's a 4-drop. You can tell how much Commander I play.
How old is this card?
It's from Commander 16.
It is 3 years old, I think, ballpark.
That's impressive.
It is a Commander staple. I opened a lot of these in sealed deck and was really mad about it. But it turns out they're worth a bunch of money.
Sounds like Snowball to me.
Thought my whole life it was a 2-drop.
Was it Tithe?
It is, yeah.
I'm going to attempt to cast Lavinia.
I played in that Pro Tour, the Ravnica Allegiance one, and we were just like throwing them away in draft. I feel so dumb.
This resolved. Hell yes.
Interesting decision point for me now is that I can kill it, but I don't know if I need it to stop Breya from doing stuff.
Yeah. I would argue that Not letting Breya hit the board is particularly relevant, and also not letting Ishai hit the board is pretty good.
Easy to say now that your commander's in play over there.
Yeah, my commander's a 2/2 that's squishy.
My commander's a 1/1.
I mean, but Breya's castable next turn off of 4 lands, right?
I was going to say, I can play Breya. It only stops
you can play spells anyway. But it's going to stop him from doing like Adnaz and those sorts of things, which he's going to be trying to do.
Yeah, yeah, it's too cold.
What? I'm not trying to. Don't worry about me. You guys play.
Yeah, take it easy.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm all for a good hate bear. Let's just leave it there. Who cares?
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. The texture of my draw also is pro Lavinia. I'm worried about Breya.
Why is everyone worried about me? You guys need to.
You imagine the real threat. It's gotta be the necropotence is a little more sus than the Lavinia.
Yeah, right. I know it looks kind of gruesome on the front of the card, but it's innocent, I promise.
Seems legit.
This card was so scary in my childhood. Like, this is one of the first Magic cards I remember seeing.
I've got to just keep the whole paying to dig through my deck, because I failed to hit land drops and or dorks again.
Oh no.
So I'll just pay 8 life to keep cards I don't need in my hand. Play a spear.
I like that one.
I don't like this, because this lets people play stuff through Lavinia, but okay.
That's true.
Oh, it does!
Yeah.
Yeah,
but that's fun.
Ooh, okay, all right.
For the watchers at home who want to understand that one, Lavinia has two sets of abilities. One of them is opponents can't cast non-creature spells with mana value greater than the number of lands that player controls. Sphere doesn't affect that. But also, if an opponent casts a spell and no mana was spent to cast it, counter that spell. So now we have to pay one for our Force of Wills through Sphere of Resistance, which counts as paying mana for Lavinia. However, we still can't cast Force of Will because we don't have 5 lands to do that. So Lavinia does a tight little squeeze on games of Magic.
So I had a little decision tree moment of, do I cast a Sphere of Resistance? Do I cast another thing that does a Sphere of Resistance style effect? Or do I cast a Rip? And I just don't feel like Rip was going to have much of an impact on Breya's current situation.
Not interested in your commander at all.
It does turn off the, like,
I can't cast Selvala because I don't have 3 lands.
Non-creature spells.
It's non-creature.
Uh-oh.
Vince, did you do an oopsie?
Oh, I haven't played with Lavinia in a long time. Oh, yeah. No.
Everybody makes this mistake.
Everyone who doesn't play Vintage makes that mistake.
Yeah, exactly, because she was a hot moment in Modern and Legacy, and then we just don't play her anymore, right? She's not that good there.
She's still an asshole in Vintage, I promise.
Oh, I don't think I played Vintage since War of the Spark came out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do they still play, like, Pokemon and shit over there, or have they...
Well, Lurrus is still banned in spite of the companion change.
Oh, I forgot that got banned there.
But even without the companion... Even with the companion change, Lurrus might be pretty redonk. What do you think, Bosh? Will they unban Lurrus, do you think?
In what format?
In Vintage.
They already did.
What? Lurrus got unbanned?
Yeah, yeah. When they changed the rules, they unbanned Lurrus.
It's restricted.
No, it's not even restricted because you can play 4 in your deck and nobody cares because it's just a 3 mana creature.
And
restricting it to your companion doesn't do anything. So it's just full unbanned in Vintage. Legacy is the only format where you can't play Lurrus right now.
Man, it's fucking wild. I did not realize this.
Yeah, that happened.
Testament to my lack of playing Vintage. The major reason I don't play Vintage is because to record a league, it can take hours to get the games.
Yes.
Especially in my time zone.
Yep. It's
otherwise
rough.
It'd be fine to like slam them. Maybe that's a thing. Maybe if I slam some videos for it, we could like encourage more people to play it. Because I've enjoyed it in the past, but
yeah, the format is nice, but I mean, also just the limitation of like, I'm having so much fun on Magic Online, I'll go buy paper cards. Like, that pathway doesn't exist in Vintage, except for unless you're Jeff Bezos.
I've been just in this like mood the last like 2 weeks basically, where anytime I promise this has like relevancy to you saying Jeff Bezos, but like the last 2 weeks I've just been like obsessed with Bo Burnham's Inside.
I was literally gonna make the joke, are you gonna come up Bo Burnham's Inside, but then you went to it anyway.
I literally Every time I hear Jeff Bezos mentioned now, I immediately start singing that song in my head.
I sing it to my wife a little bit. I'll just sing Jeff Bezos randomly, and she's like,
"Yeah, good job, Jeff Bezos."
Say much, she just ignores me.
You did it.
So my fiance and I, she and I like bonded originally over that we both
Jeff
liked
Bezos? Bo Burnham.
Well, yes, Jeff Bezos. But we both liked Bo Burnham years ago. And so when we watched Inside, we both really liked it. I liked it evidently a lot more than she did. And I've been like singing the songs. And she's like, Caleb, I need you to tell me if you're okay or not. You've been singing the I Feel Like Shit song a little bit too much, and I'm worried about you.
Yeah, the one that creeps into my head when I'm laying in bed at night is the anything and everything all of the time about the internet. Like,
yeah, internet. It's also the one I listen to the most after the fact, and it's also probably the catchiest, I think, in terms of a hook.
Yeah, it's both like the most fun song, I think the most well-written song, and also the most horrifying song.
Did you see the comment that went viral on the YouTube version of it where it was like, this song sounds like a... So this is someone else's comment, not mine, but it was, this song sounds like a villainous song, but the villain has already won.
Oh, and
I was
yeah.
like, yeah, yep. that's pretty succinct.
Just the scene of him, like, laying on the ground, just being like, maybe not letting these giant corporations into our everyday lives wasn't a great idea.
Yeah. I mean... But, like, things like YouTube and stuff transform my life. So, I mean, as much as the algorithm is radicalizing people into, like, far-right crazy places, it had a positive effect on me, so... it's
gotta be fine then, right?
Yeah, it's gotta be okay. Yeah, it's rough. It's rough. But, yeah, Inside was amazing. My wife enjoyed it, but I think it resonated with me more because I spent time fucking about with cameras and lights, not to the extent that he does.
Yeah.
But, yeah. What are you putting into exile over there? A22EN.
Bunch of random blue cards.
Ah, no swan song. I'm safe.
Whoa.
The Sphere of Resistance was just not good, was it?
Mm-hmm. Wah, wah,
the Sphere of Resistance is really good for you last turn. It's not good for me.
Did you just tutor for that, Bosh?
Hell yeah.
Oh my gosh. Vince, I had it!
Look, I wanted to. I'm just very scared of Breya just popping off. So I was like, I gotta do something.
That's fair.
If I'd hit a fourth land, maybe my turn would have been completely. A third land, sorry.
We've already discussed this is a 1/1 creature. You can all relax.
Yeah, it doesn't do anything. It's just a 1/1.
It's a 1/1.
I cast it twice during Proliferate Cubes run on Modo, and both times I died.
Yeah, that's what's going to happen.
That's the end of that story.
There's nothing to worry about.
I cast it and die. Oh, you're going to die. Okay, cool.
Oh, why is that what I drew? Is that good?
Do not play any form of Narset style effect, or I will get.
Oh, I don't play Narset. no, I play blue white Narset, which is even better. How greedy do I want to be?
I was going to say I don't know what blue-white Narset does, but I definitely didn't know what Lavinia does, so... Yeah,
you have a huge blind spot on blue-white cards.
Gonna play this...
Ooh, is it time to just spew?
No. I think we're gonna just play really...
Ooh.
Really, conservatively here.
It's gonna make a second Lavinia?
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, that makes sense. I like it.
You? I'd love it if you made a Birds of Paradise.
That would actually be really awesome.
That gets out of the Sphere of Resistance.
Ugh, you didn't go with the birds?
Coward.
I did pick coward. A bird. What are you talking about?
Okay, that is fair. You did pick a bird.
It is a bird. I just realized this is a monk, too. That fits my brand. I'm in for that.
Okay.
I thought your brand was enchantments that mill things.
What?
The Quarter Cunning?
Oh, okay. I was briefly into that card. That's true.
Sure.
No, my brand is largely based on Monastery Mentor and Monk Tokens.
Oh, I'm aware. I've seen you make some paper Monk Tokens.
I've done it once
Let's
or twice.
Let's go, Sylvan Library. Let's fucking go.
Is it good?
Callahan, let me see it, please. Oh, there we go. Okay. I mean, it's fine. Oh.
Is it a land?
Is a resource. Let's go.
Got a land. That a boy. That's the spirit.
All right, got there.
That's it. I did. I got there. Oh.
I feel duty bound to remind you can cast your commander. Since I was too late last round.
It's the consideration here. Just tapping out for Selvala does feel very slow.
Well, to be fair, we're all kind of having slow starts compared to Zach.
What? I have a slow start too. Don't worry about it.
Yeah. So Lavinia is stopping anyone else from doing anything, and Sphere is stopping Callahan from doing anything. So
perfect equilibrium.
Yeah. So Breya gets to do what she's gonna do, I guess.
I actually thought I. My turn, I guess.
Parlay is such a weird mechanic.
It's a very strange mechanic.
It really is. So each player reveals the top card of their library. For each non-land card revealed this way, PK gets green and gains one. Then everyone draws a card. Okay. Interesting. It's like group hug, but only fake because everyone's gonna die to all your mana.
Yeah. There's like a Twiddle Storm version of this deck that's pretty neat.
That's hot.
I mean, this version plays the Umbral Mantle thing, so it does untap her.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if that... Honestly, I should have really asked Donlord what the lines with the Umbral Mantle were. I assume it is Selvala that you put it on primarily.
Oh, that's strong not scepter. Great.
What's wrong with Isochron Scepter? Don't worry about it.
This is...
Well, both the blue players tapped out with the sphere in place. They can't even pretend they've got counter magic.
Yeah, I mean...
Put your dramatic reversal underneath of it.
All right, I'm going to be honest with you. I thought Isochron Scepter cast the spell, but it just makes a copy.
It does cast the spell. It makes a copy and then casts the copy.
Oh, awesome. All right, so then I do have you guys dead.
Yeah, the sphere allows you to cast it.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. Sphere would have made this impossible.
Oh, wait, maybe I... Oh, no, I do have enough.
Ooh. Untap all non-land permanents. Okay, so you have infinite blue.
Yeah, you'll be able to.
You have up to 22 blue or black mana. Ishai is enormous, though.
I have a brain freeze in my hand and counter spells.
Okay, you don't need the counter spells.
Okay, well, yeah. I do have a brain freeze in my hand, so if this is casting it, I can go infinite.
Let me just check my list real quick and make sure that I'm dead to that.
I kept the world's slowest hand.
That's all right. You're a stacks deck. Sometimes you just gotta live and die.
For a full start, I was like, I'll just keep a hand with two lands.
How dare you consider that two lands and a dork is good?
I also thought the two, a Thalia and a Sphere, and I was like, that would be enough to slow people down.
I had this dead, or I had you guys dead last turn if you didn't play the Sphere, but I had to.
I didn't play the Sphere. So the sphere did slow you down then, in spite of the Lavinia punt.
Yeah, I would have killed. I would have done this last turn if you hadn't played the sphere.
How would you have got around the Lavinia?
Because the reversals get countered, right?
Yeah, they get countered.
Okay, then no, I would not have had you dead without the sphere.
Yeah, the sphere was a punt.
All right,
it happens.
Well, now we know.
What I should have done is played nothing relevant for two turns, then died.
I mean, I'm pretty okay to just scoop.
Yeah, I'm just, I pulled my list up on my phone. I'm making sure I don't have anything that can beat a brain freeze.
Yeah, I'm checking for some sort of green shuffle in thing. But even then...
Yeah, I'm empty and ready to concede when the rest of us are.
I am also deader. Shall we go for the game two?
Yeah, let's go to game two. Good job, Zach.
Oh, man.
All right, we're back for game number two. And PleasantKenobi is on the play again.
Because what happened for the viewers at home is I loaded the wrong deck, we restarted, and I got to play again, because I got the wrong deck twice, and I get to play whenever I get the wrong deck.
Yeah, so a little behind-the-scenes look for all of the watchers. Kenobi queued up with the wrong deck the first time, and then I forgot to hit record for the first two turns of the second time, and then we re-queued again. You actually just watched our third game, and then PK had to log off because Magic Online decided we weren't friends anymore, and he couldn't join my buddy game, and then we logged back in. Moto queued up the wrong deck for him, and I was on the play, by the way, and then we refired, and now he's back on the play, so his scam is working.
Computer people at home, wasn't the same wrong deck. It was a different wrong deck.
Yeah, naturally.
Makes no sense.
That is glorious, actually. I think that's so fucking funny.
We were just talking about how bad my openers have been. I think his opener might actually be like pure gas.
I hope so. I'm rooting for everyone to have a good time. Primarily. but also hope I win.
Ooh, Horizon Canopy, let's go.
Ooh, Mox Diamond.
Oh, look at this. Look at these. Look at these accelerants.
Ooh.
Right then. I'm so excited. I'm so excited for No Force.
Oh,
come on.
No!
One time. One time.
Damn it.
One time. Why? Oh, beautiful. Look at that. Again, behind the scenes, 82EN said, sorry, I'm going to stop using that name now, but said that you don't have much disruption. I was like, it's all permanent based. Here it is. Here's the disruption.
I guess I did ask for that. This is fair.
Yeah, you did this to yourself. Honestly, so I'm so happy. Like, I loved that this Thalia resolved, and obviously PK is stoked, and then two wails of despair from the other two opponents, and I'm like, okay, that's not bad.
I mean, one mana Mox Opal is still pretty good.
Yeah, that's great.
Ugh.
How much fast mana did we keep? Oh, this is the revenge. In the game that got lost because I didn't record, Callahan mental misstepped my turn one Soul Ring, which was my only mana source to cast the Cursed Totem and Windfall in my hand. And then I just died. Missed my second land drop. Good thing that one's not in the public record.
One mana Mox Diamond again. A pretty reasonable magic card. I think that's just seems, modern play.
That feels a little bit better than a one mana Mox Opal, if I'm being honest.
But yes, I agree.
Isn't that just an Arbor Grazer that can't block?
Yeah, it's pretty close.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's one way of looking at it.
I mean, that card's nickname is Blocks Diamond, right? And this is just the inspiration. This one never could block.
Perhaps it was Zoran D. They were playing cube one day and this interaction happened. And they're like, what if we just do a body?
Yeah, what if we just put it on a terrible mid-game top deck? It's still insane on turn one and terrible in the mid-game, just like Mox Diamond.
Yeah.
Like a Tundra?
Mm. Oh, you have the cool new Tundra.
Wow, look at all these Mox Diamonds.
Turns out this card's popular.
I'm feeling left out here. And so is everyone who didn't buy cards before the reserve list ruined Magic.
Ooh, Chrome Mox. I had a Mox Diamond, and then when I saw the price of it, I sold it.
At what point?
I think I sold it at like 800.
Okay, yeah, that's pretty good.
I think I bought it at like 75. So
I've got a hypothetical for you all.
I'm ready.
If I had a Collector Oof in hand, how mad would it make you all?
Oh my god, no. Not like this. Please no.
Exactly.
Would it be
like
distressing?
This?
I can neither confirm nor deny how I will feel about that.
I'm stoked.
The weirdness is I'm going to have to say something to Donglord, but this deck doesn't have an oof in it, which is wild, because it seems like it's the... I guess there's a lot of artifact mana in the deck as well. I guess there's that.
Oh, you know what? That does make sense, because one of your main combos is with Unburl Mantle.
Yeah, you'd be stepping on your own balls too much. The Donglord knows all about that.
I would love to step on my own balls sometimes.
Like Mox Diamond discard, Chromox discard, and you're like, oof. God.
Yeah.
That's the fucking combo. In a Star City Open once, Kyle Bogomis vialed in an oof against me, and I was like, yeah, that's the combo.
Nice.
He did win that game.
I believe it. Kyle wins most games he plays, as it turns out.
I do not want to pass through my combat. It's Commander and I get to attack. Wow.
Yeah, that's
probably
true.
Attack the black deck.
What? No, don't.
After you drew like 1,000 cards of Necropotence, I do think I need to slap.
Yeah, the Necropotence ad nauseum deck, I think we want to.
Look, I'll take this too if it means there are no oofs or Stony Silences coming.
I've played, I've probably won plenty of modern games where I've sided in my Stony Silences, not my Vials out. And on stream too, when people are like, do you want to take the Vials out? I'm like, no.
Now, what are the chances I'll draw both?
Nah. Yeah. And sometimes, this is back when like Opal was legal, right? Old school affinity. The good fun affinity in modern. None of this hard skills nonsense.
Bah, bah, bah.
Oh,
that's
wow.
Pretty good.
That's a good
wish
one.
I had a Collector Oof.
Yeah, I didn't have a Mox Diamond, so I get this instead.
I wish I had a Phantasmal Image right now.
Dockside Extortionist feels like a card that was designed for a different format that then was good in Commander, but lo and behold, it was just in a Commander deck.
Yeah, it's preposterous that this was Commander on purpose.
Yeah, this feels like true name the other way around, but it just wasn't.
Yeah.
It's just one.
Card's a little busted.
Isn't it like 40 out. Bucks as well?
55.
It's closer to 55. Yeah.
I know because I bought one last night to make this deck in paper.
I ripped apart the precon the other day when I was like, I was going to buy a dockside, keep the sealed product. I was like, no, there's no way. I'm just going to rip the precon open.
Yeah, fuck it.
Did you actually buy the dockside straight up or did you just buy the precon?
I bought the dockside.
Which is the precon's like free.
Is it?
Yeah, seriously.
If you want the dockside, yeah.
I didn't even
In
look.
In all fairness,
I assumed that the market would adjust for that a little bit.
No, the precon's like $70 or something, and dockside itself is like 55. But it also
if you get lucky, you can just buy it for like $40 at Walmart.
That happens too.
I do think the precon though doesn't really have much else in it. So other than perhaps picking up like a soul ring and a command tower and random like a couple of dollar bits that are useful, it's a lot of like just chaff.
Right, there's a Savine's Wreck in there.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's true.
That's a legacy card. All right, yeah, I should have poked around a little, but it's too late now. I now own one casual commander deck and one cEDH deck, and I think I'm done building them.
All right, I will say, in fairness, I did just draw this for turn.
Fuck!
Don't worry about it, it's fine.
You know what? There's a ban out, so it's probably okay.
There's a what
now?
Butdranus.
Oh yeah,
that's true.
I can't play my commander.
I just
ordered loads of enchantment bits for Enchantress because the new one, the 2-mana one from Horizons.
Okay.
If I don't open one in my booster box that I've got coming for the channel, I'm going to have to go fishing for one. I don't own a Seraph Sanctum. I'm like, I might as well get one because it's just an investment at this point.
Yeah.
Yeah, those cards are never going down.
I just had to buy some green reserve list cards for Chatterfang. Those are way more expensive than I thought they would be.
Wow, the second Dockside Extortionist is much better than the first one.
They do tend to stack.
Yeah.
As it happens.
Yikes.
All right, let's see if you get the top card.
What does... Let's say Dockside Extortionist is part of a cycle, right? I don't know what... I don't give a shit about the cards. I'm just, like, theory casting
no.
here. What the fuck would the white version get? Would you gain life equal to them? Would you get 2 life per artifact?
I think the white version deck for makes you sacrifice permanents you control for each artifact or enchantment they have.
Or it would be literal Dockside. If Dockside was a white card, it'd ask the opponent to pay 1, if not, you get to make the treasure.
That probably sounds.
Yeah, and it would be a 3-mana 1/1.
And the other thing is, that sounds more like an extortionist too, right? Like,
and it also sounds more reasonable as a card.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is not an extortionist. This is just stealing.
My favorite thing to do, I'm not getting on a high horse because I think some of the new white cards are actually really, really good, so I can't complain too much. But I like to look at gold cards, like Teferi, Time Ravenel, whatever, and imagine what does the blue version and what does the white version look like? And that card, I imagine if it was blue, would do the exact same things. And if it was white, it would do half the things. And I think that happens a lot with gold cards.
I mean, didn't they, like, say the quiet part on out loud when they said the, like, what is it, the Soul Tie Turtle? The reason they made it Soul Tie was because they thought it would be cool to, like, make a bunch of tapped zombies come into play untapped. And I was just like, yeah, that's what people are going to do with it, for sure.
Yeah. Well, my explosive start was pretty bad against this Dockside Extortionist. So,
the Ristic Study is a little rough.
Yeah, that's scary.
We'll say, in my defense of my Ristic Study, I have one card in hand and it's not good. So, you guys are safe for like a turn.
Okay.
Oh, you just got another card.
I drew a card.
Okay.
Got 3 mana.
Ooh, I did get another turn. Ooh, nice.
Wow, that's crazy to me that is a mana ability that nobody can respond to that does so many things. Just keeping track of that on like the rules level. Because I just blinked and there was a new card in my hand. Like, where the hell did that come from?
I had a moment there as well where I was like, that was sudden. Okay. What is the best way to deal with this board state? I need more disruptive elements. By disruptive, I mean things that blow everything up.
Oh, let's leave the permanents alone for a little bit.
I'm ready for a reset. Burn it down.
I don't agree with this. Let's not reset things.
Sorry, I'm just thinking through lines. The new card plus the tutor makes things interesting. God, I wish there was an oof in this deck so bad.
It would be good, like, exactly here.
Yeah, exactly.
Dockside is going to be good.
I think it's okay to play cards that counter to your game plan if they can be backbreaking for everyone else, right?
Well, like in decks like Razzicats, which is, you can like play Oof in that, even though you play like LED as part of your main combo, because you could just sack it to Razzicath, right? So
yeah,
it's like, it just, I don't know, it depends on the build. We had a huge discussion about this a few weeks ago because somebody was playing Marwyn in the league and didn't have Oof in the deck, and like it sparked this whole discussion about whether or not that's correct.
Oh, I want to pay, but I don't think I can.
Don't worry about it. You don't need to pay. It's all right. Fine.
You have that green just floating there. Oh, it's too late. Party's over.
He's got to cast the thing he gets, which is totally reasonable. I understand.
Exactly. I'm just going to give the Breya player the win if I'm not careful.
Again.
Again, yeah.
Linvala, if that's in your deck, would be pretty tight. Well, no, Linvala doesn't do much in the sports. Never mind.
I like that. Have been good.
Green.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't stop artifacts, right?
Yeah, I was out to lunch. Okay. Don't mind me.
I'm gonna have to stop paying, aren't I?
No. Don't worry about it. You're good.
I mean, you're about to have a zillion mana.
Maybe. Yeah, I'm gonna pay this time round.
This is sweet. Having not being super exposed to Commander in general, especially cEDH, the idea of Quirion Ranger plus Selvala just did things for me. That was the tutor that made me really happy.
Can we address that they thought it was okay to put Quirion Ranger in Modern, and how I don't think that's okay at all?
I mean, what's the worst they'll do? Like, make elves better? I don't know. Doesn't seem that bad.
I guess.
It seems so modern.
It feels like something that is just asking to get broken.
That might be true.
But I am okay with them pushing the limits. Like, when Companion was debuted and everyone was like, what are you doing, you idiots? Marrow posed the hypothetical, would you rather us never push or push too hard sometimes? And like, we have a ban list to manage the push too hard sometimes moments. So I'm cool with Quirion Ranger. Let it ride. If it breaks something, then sure, ban it. But then like, if it facilitates Maverick or a resurgence of elves in a format that doesn't currently have those things.
Wirewood Symbio.
Oh, we're going
not
off.
Not happy.
I'm so happy
about
I'm
this.
So happy.
Yeah, this is going to be bad.
This is great.
I'm pretty sure this is representing... Oh, you can only do that once a turn, right?
Yeah.
Well, you can query in again now because you return.
I can query in again, yeah. I've got a little bit more gas in the tank.
Yeah, and query in again, and then Selvala again. You need the mirror entity to go infinite, but you've already symbioted, so it's over.
He's going to get to bring Wing Mirrors and get the tax on.
This heuristic study is so
low key. Though,
just don't pay for it. You totally fine. Just let it happen.
How does the rest of the board feel of me refilling Bray's hand? That's just terrible, right?
It's fine.
Yeah, I'm not super interested in that happening.
I'm not super interested in it, especially considering if you're going to play another taxing piece, nobody's going to be able to pay the tax. So
no. You're fine. Just let it go. We'll have a nice fun game where we all get to cast our spells.
So he started your turn with one card in hand, and he's currently up to five. So
yeah, I know, but
you could also lean in, like right in the fucking bucket.
I'm playing Scavala, right? I've got
at this point, like there's not a lot you could do about it.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Like, you've already like.
Well, it's too late. I've just paid twice. I wish you'd all said this before.
Ooh, got him. Best of both worlds.
Oh, this is gas. This is real gas.
Uh-oh.
Hang on.
Okay.
He found some real gas.
Okay, I'm going to stop paying stuff. Fuck it, who cares? I don't even know if this is good chat and comment section, so just...
Oh shit.
Oh, no.
Ride or die, fam. Here we go.
No, I'm not paying anymore.
Yeah, you're good. You didn't need to pay the first two times. You're fine, man. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, you're
all
right.
All creatures
have paid.
Haste. Let's go.
Yeah, it's time to party. Yes.
Oh, hello.
Yes. A soul ring action.
No, you can have your Rhystic Study cards. Who cares?
The funny thing is, I now have many cards in my hand, and I'm still not doing actual anything with any of them yet.
So I pay two here, and it makes Quirion Ranger plus Jiraga attack for four. So I'm paying three to get four, which is fine. And it's probably not enough, though, is the problem.
You already activated Ranger, right?
I did, yeah. I want another way to bounce it, really, but I don't know if the deck has it.
You're out of forest, too.
Oh, that is true. Yeah. Another land drop at that point. Wait, what? Oh, no. What am I on about? I need to go way too leveled up for that. So I only get three. I don't get to man off Ranger this turn.
So oh, yeah. I forgot about level five. Yikes.
I'm going to play my land for the turn. I guess so I'll just play this.
Lane yet?
No, I have played land for the turn. For the Savannah. Okay. Right? Well, I've given the Breya player a million cards, so it's up to you lot to stop them.
And I have my magistrate.
I actually am not doing anything. My hand is all mana. They have no payoff.
Yep. And there definitely won't be two more turns worth of Rhystic Study before you have to do anything.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure Vince just kills us if he untaps again.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Pretty sure that's correct.
That sounds accurate to me.
What are you talking about? It's just mana. Look at Vintage, right? And look at Legacy. Decks don't win by making big mana. Or at least 90% of them don't. Huh? Tapping foreheads, proving a point.
I'm not mana sure if that's true.
Mana is for cowards. All the best can I quote you on that?
Tend to be 0/1 or better when cast for nothing, right?
This mana is for cowards. Never paying.
Whoa.
This Thalia is bullshit, by the way.
I did draw Vryn Ringmare. That was the alternative to developing my board state further.
Yeah, I hope I'm able to punish that, but probably not. All right, so...
Jesus, a 6/2?
Yeah, for now.
+1/+1 for each artifact you control.
We're the same
broken
size.
I think this needs to be banned in Commander.
And makes a treasure. When you cast
I'm going to have to tweet about this. That needs to be banned. It's too good.
Say, if you cast a storm spell or something, it might actually look too good. Oh, no.
I mean, it's very, very good, but I mean...
I'm going to get a look at these 11 cards in Zach's hand.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Well, yeah.
What's the etiquette at a cEDH table for looking at a player's hand and just reading the cards out to the rest of the table?
You can.
What's the etiquette on that? I know you can do it.
Like, but... you don't... You generally share information that you think is like relevant to the rest of the table.
Now I have to decide if I want to counter the Gataxian probe or not.
Just a lot of people will like use the information they get in there to like politic the board.
Yeah, of course. That makes a lot more sense. It's like you know, Commander outside of the CDH space especially is full of so many unwritten rules and weirdness.
Yeah.
Hold on. Like, before he says anything. Brian, I would like to point out that the card you think in my hand that does kill people does not work because my Savine's Reclamation is under my Chromebox. Just want to say that.
Okay. Lesson learned or considered.
Because he has a breach.
No. Zach, if we're going to be friends, I can hide some of this information for a little while.
Ooh, what does this friendship entail? What are we talking about here?
Don't make friends though, he's about to kill everyone.
I don't know. We'll find out. I'm
gonna call you Saruman now.
I don't have to agree to anything yet, so I'm just gonna continue playing the game.
We're
gonna
hit him for six. Oh boy!
I'm not done casting spells yet. Now we all have Mox Diamond. The whole playset is in play.
I absolutely regret paying for the Rhystic Study initially before I decided to.
Yeah, you should.
Yeah.
Yeah, it happens. Absolutely.
We
tricked you real good. If the Breya player wins, boss, you tricked yourself.
Yeah. Congratulations.
You played yourself, yeah.
DJ Khaled.
I do love that they convince you, like, you gotta pay. You're gonna have a lot of mana, man. You gotta pay. And then you paid, like, three times. Like, oh, we're totally not gonna pay, but you should definitely keep paying.
Yeah, definitely.
That's a big bone of contention, especially at more casual tables as well, of, you should be paying for Rhystic. I know Toma, like, Goldfish, is mad for it. And I'm like, I agree. But, like, if you can develop a good board state or put yourself in a good position, then who cares?
Or you can just hope what happens here happens where I draw 12 cards and they don't do anything.
I just realized I punched this turn.
You just
real
told
hard.
Bosch that the card in your hand cannot kill the table because you're missing one card.
Well, it's the card that looks like it kills the table, but in fact, it does actual nothing with Sabine's Reclamation exiled.
Okay.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, this should have been the first spell I played this turn instead of the last one. So mistakes were made.
The card in my hand was Intuition, for the record. So you get to pick and give me something.
Yeah, you don't have great piles for Intuition.
Well, Intuition works if I have Savine's Reclamation. Then I just auto-win, but without it, I can't do anything. You just give me one of the cards or whatever. You
should have played Ishai and hasted it at someone for one damage.
Oh, yeah.
That would have been that's generally how you play Jeska, is you play the other partner first.
Well, yeah, but you're generally not dead to a board full of X1s either.
That's also true.
I should have Jeska'd first, killed Thalia, and then...
If you kill the Thalia, I might be able to dig us out of this.
And I don't really know if I need to.
I think killing the Thalia opens the floodgates, right? Don't do that.
Well, Thalia unlocks Lavinia, which might be worse against Zach, who has one land.
That's true.
I definitely am going to have another land. I promise there's a land in my hand.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, but it shuts him off.
You've probably seen a land in his hand, right?
Light him
up.
Most
the things.
Okay. I've got to do some stuff now.
Yeah, that feels correct.
Yeah, I just wish I did that before I spent mana on my Gataxian Probe instead of netting mana off Gataxian Probe. And yeah, mistakes were made. But
it happens.
Let's hope I get another turn. HermitDruid is at home screaming at the camera. It's all right.
So I can untap Zavala, I can bounce the Ranger. I can trade Ranger. Yeah, let's do that.
Classic legacy trick, unkillable elves.
Wirewood Symbiote might be the card in Legacy I've lost the most games to, playing DT.
I despise Wirewood Symbiote. It just never lets your Jitte hit ever.
I love
your Jitte should be able to hit. Should be able to get that Jitte hit in, and then give those elves the minus one counters they deserve.
Man, the Selvala, like, drawing me, let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cards is pretty cash money.
Yeah, that was pretty nice.
I think I meant to murder you before you get to untap with them, but it's just not happening.
You know, it do be like that sometimes.
Just gonna stick some regen shields on.
Bubble up.
Why would Symbiote should be an elf? That's my hot take of the day.
Oh, please no.
But only when I'm playing it.
Okay,
that's only when I'm playing it.
Before Creator of Behemoth, Why would Symbiote was frequently an elf in Legacy with the Mirror Entity kill.
Huh. Wait, how did Mirror Entity fix it?
Does Mirror Entity turns all creatures into all creature types when you activate it?
Yeah, so...
Oh, I didn't know that.
So the combo is Heritage Druid, Wirewood Symbiote, and Mirror Entity. You pay one, turn all your things into elves, then tap those three things, then you pick up the symbiote to itself, replay it, pay one again, you get mana. It's an infinite mana loop.
Sure. I knew Mirror Entity changed the power and toughness. I didn't know it gave them all creature types.
Yep.
Yeah, the reason Bosh knows that is that he loves... monks.
I do love monks.
This is part of the monk test.
When I ask people to name every monk in Magic, they have to say include that one.
They have to name every card in Magic, because the caveat in brackets is with a mirror entity.
Yep, that's how I get them.
I'm gonna say, I'm actually trying to build Chatterfang. This is not really related to it, but I'm trying to build Chatterfang right now just a normal EDH deck. And it turns out the squirrels are so bad, I actually have to play some changelings. Just as squirrels, because I just don't have enough squirrels.
So what's the best monk in Modern, then?
The best monk in Modern is Monastery Mentor.
What's the second best monk in Modern?
The tokens it makes.
And third?
There has to be a better monk. There has to be.
The best Modern legal monk might be Changeling Outcast. I'm a big fan of that one.
I was thinking down the lines of, like, where do the changelings land? Because obviously Changeling Outcast is any play in Modern? Obviously it's played in Legacy. I don't think it's played in Modern.
Yeah, it's probably not played in Modern. I was asked to do it once. I did make Modern Ninjas with Changeling Outcast, but it turns out Yuriko is a big deal.
Because the joke always used to be, it's Chameleon Colossus or Mirror Entity, right? But it's funny that Changeling Outcast changed that conversation, that it's now, like, the third best crab ever printed, and, like, stuff like that.
I think we found a better monk than Monastery Mentor Monk Token. How about Rocks War Monk?
That card used to be a Legacy playable card.
I was going to say, in Modern, not so much, but if you're talking like Extended from 10 years ago, perhaps, I don't know.
Yeah, Bant countertop, before we had miracles, before Terminus changed the game for everyone, Bant countertop with Rock's War Monk was a legacy deck briefly.
Okay. There are not very many monks, though.
Oh, God. We're dead.
This looks scary. I don't know.
No, we're not. This is me trying to find an answer for either of these things.
Breya currently has 17 cards in hand.
Yeah.
Honestly, they don't do anything. There's 17 cards and none of them do anything.
Yep.
I would be amazed if I get to untap.
Yeah, I have no faith in being able to untap. Now that this looks scary, he has Hullbreacher, Grinding Station, Cabal Ritual.
But how do you know about the Grinding Station?
I can see everything.
Oh, darn it, okay.
Unsubstantiate to protect it. There is a lot of mana here. Yeah, Intuition, Hullbreacher with Unsubstantiate backup are what I can see.
I promise the Intuition doesn't do anything, though. Well, it does, like, I get to live for three cards and you get to give me one, but it's not, like, auto-win like it would be.
Uh-huh.
Because I need the Savine's Reclamation to make it so that no matter what you give me, I get what I want. You know what
is
I mean?
Selvala actually played at higher tiers for cEDH? Because it feels like her downside is too severe.
There is a list, but it's pretty fringe.
Yeah. Because it feels like you cannot utilize her until you're at a stage where you would be ahead.
Yeah, and you can't get ahead without utilizing her either. Which is
there's a small window where I like might have drawn a few more cards that would have really pushed me over the edge, like if I hit Cradle and stuff like that, or another Tutor or something. But yeah, that's I made a load of mana and then just refilled everyone's hands. Didn't feel that strong.
Oh wow! All right, I think you guys are dead, but I don't know.
I regret all my life choices.
I tried to play as optimally as possible on that turn.
Look, Thalia is dead, so I'm expecting either of you blue players to have something.
I mean, you do know that I just tutored a Force of Will.
Do
we know that?
Yes.
Yeah, you just tutored that to the top.
Mystical.
Oh, right, yeah, I wasn't paying attention. Right, we're good then. We're Gucci.
I don't know that we are.
Yeah, we're
but
fine.
I'm going to do my best.
So, awkwardly, my plan when I killed Thalia was that Lavinia would be in play by the time that Zach got a turn, but I have Dranith Magistrate in play.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's nice because it shuts off breach lines. So that could...
Yeah, I guess it's non-zero, and Bray is not coming into play. I don't know if that's actually part of any combo or if it's just there for the colors.
That's probably some infinite mana stuff, right? Yeah. Well, you have to suck off, I suppose.
Oh, we had a demonic tutor. All right, so can DT for a wheel and breach wheel us at the very least if there's not a more deterministic line than that?
I promise I'm not doing that.
Okay.
This is not good for you, but also that is not what I'm doing.
I'm smelling a pier.
I don't think I'm
sorry.
My deck, if I'm being honest with you. I'm pretty sure I don't.
Bosh thinks someone's pissed themselves.
Yeah. If I smell a pier, I'd be pretty... I'd wonder who's in my house.
Oh. Okay, I'm here now.
Yeah, P-E-E-R also means someone who is peeing.
Took me a moment.
It's the same
word. If you smell toast, it's a stroke. If you smell a pier, you're at the seaside.
Right.
Or burning your toast.
Is this the same win con again?
I don't have the brain freeze.
Yeah, this one's not going to work, though.
I can do a really big fluster storm. Oh, because of the Dranith Magistrate, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I should have tutored for something else then.
Oh wow. So so you're saying there's a chance.
I mean, he has unsubstantiate in hand. That might be the pinch point where we fight over it, but he also has Flusterstorm. Unsubstantiate and Flusterstorm in hand. And lots of mana. I think we're in trouble.
And only 6 mana.
Yeah, that's it. Maybe I'll pitch the unsubstantiate to Isochron Scepter.
I was not going to do that.
No, nope.
It was a good effort.
Didn't fall for it.
Lotus P toll.
How many cards did I get in my graveyard?
This has a urination theme deck over there.
I see you drew every fast mana rock in your deck. Every slight slow mana rock in your deck, I meant.
How dumb is Wisdom Study? Like, looking at it from a contemporary design.
So, in a...
Couldn't exist.
Oh, here we go.
Okay.
It's go time.
Going down.
Well, I'm going to be very transparent with the table. I have 3 elves and a Vryn Wingman and a land in my hand. I ain't doing shit.
Yeah. Remember
you're getting
that
my
time?
Best attempt here.
Yeah, remember the time I killed Thalia at the end of the turn instead of the beginning of the turn? I am holding a miscast, but I can't cast it because I spent a mana on Gitaxian Probe instead.
Yeah. I don't even think miscast gets there. Because he has three mana untapped right
well,
here.
Well, he's going to fluster you and then go... Oh, yeah, there is still three mana there. That's right. Though, if I net mana off Gitaxian Probe instead of spend mana, that's... I guess it was mana neutral, so that is only plus one, not plus two. I also have Muddle the Mixture, but I don't know that I could have gotten up to two blue. Oh, but the miscast taps him out of activating Isochron Scepter.
Mm-hmm.
So that's not nothing.
Yeah, it is not that's nothing.
That's potentially everything, right?
Yeah.
is that the only line?
Yeah, I mean, I don't have it available because I bought it on my... I missequenced my own turn.
Yeah.
But that line would exist otherwise. I wish I had a Flusterstorm with this Stormkiln artist. Jeez.
Yeah, no kidding. That'd be hot.
That'd be very hot.
I think that would be bannable. I'd have to tweet about it.
Just ban everything.
Everyone's just talking about it. Just bans. Ban nonstop. It's either preview season or we're talking about banning stuff in Commander.
In Legacy, it's both.
That is magic.
I don't know if you've kept up with the Legacy discourse around Modern Horizons 2, but...
Yeah, I was shitposting about why don't we just ban the fucking Delver? Let's just be done with it.
Yeah, when people are calling for bans literally the day the set comes out, like, all right, yeah. Sure.
I think the game is over now.
I don't have a kill, but I have some things that can get me close to one.
Ooh, okay, let's see it. Yeah. I'll F6 then. I'll stop pretending that my Bosho is mine.
I've also F6. Yeah, he's netting one mana.
I have Breya, right? Breya is just actual infinite.
Oh, is that how that works? Yeah. All right.
Yeah, I can Breya you now that I'm looking at it.
All right. I'm content to concede this game.
Yep.
I also have a Force Negation in my hand.
Is Breya infinite?
It's your turn. All right. Zach is the winner.
But hang on, is it Breya infinite though? Because when you sack Breya to herself, she costs more and you're not netting any more mana?
You don't need to. You need to just
sack her. I'm already at infinite mana.
Yeah, he has infinite mana.
Oh, you generate infinite mana before you start sacking her. Yeah, okay, sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah, well, guess I shouldn't have used this commander.
Lesson learned. We're back for the final game, and we've had some deck changes, but I'm on the play, and I'm still doing the same thing. If you've changed your deck, please tell us what it is and what the basic plan is as we come around to you.
Yeah. I'm playing what I call Rectorfit, which is a Thrasios Timna Academy Rector Protean Hulk deck that is pretty much looking to turbo out either of those and win the game. It's pretty all right.
That sounds pretty great. I'm into that. I have a card in my hand that I'm not quite sure what to do with, and I'm really intimidated by it.
That's how I like to play Magic.
Yeah, yeah. I'm like, this is either phenomenal, or I'm just going to pitch it to Chromox. I'm going to pitch something to Chromox, but to decide what.
Spoiler alert, he has a Chromox, guys.
Yeah. I mean, that's coming into play. I'm on the play, and I'm not passing the turn without it, so.
Did you think? I'm going to Force Negation this straight into your exile zone.
I'm playing the same commander, but I added a Collector Oof and finally got hold of a Finale of Devastation, which wasn't available earlier when I went to the deck.
Such an odd thing to be out of.
It is very random.
All yeah, right, we talked about it a little bit, but Azmaran, Dekul, Dekarada, whatever, is a zero-drop creature, so you can just get her for two with Finale. Hot modern technology, folks.
It is hot. And I have switched. I am now playing Najeela because I got my comboing in. I was happy with that. Now I want to bring some beats. So I am playing Najeela, and I've never played this deck. So excuse me if I'm not, you know, an expert on it. But basically the plan is to beat down. And Najeela lets you get extra attack steps. There are cards in this deck that go infinite with that ability. But then you just make a bunch of warriors and you beat down. That's what you do.
Basically, if you see a Derevi, the game is over.
What does Derevi do?
Makes it so that whenever one of your warriors attacks, you can untap something that something that, makes any color, or even if you don't have that, you can just make the ability to just go infinite.
Yeah, it's infinite mana, right? Because you hit them on tap. You know, on tap mana, right?
Okay.
Yeah, so I was trying to like cast a spell and explain that.
Yeah,
all
the same time. It became very complicated. I was like, I was tempted to ask if you were okay because you.
Yeah, I was trying to figure out what I was doing and talk at the same time, and it was not going well.
I think he's okay because he just cast a turn one Academy Rector.
That's what I'm saying.
That's quietly, look at this Rector Fit deck. Just slam the Rector on turn one.
He's giving a very convoluted description to like hide it, but there's a Rector in play right now.
Fuck's sake, I shouldn't have signed up again with this fucking elf deck, should I? Don Lord, if you're watching, fuck you. Jesus, I played a one drop and you got a Rector and like 1,000 mana.
Who's his commander? Do those matter?
No, this is a very commander agnostic deck.
Okay.
It's playing Thrasios Timna for the colors.
Fair enough.
Yeah, if they had mattered, the turn one Rector makes them not matter anymore.
Yeah. I saw like my opening hand and I was like, oh, hey, that's a turn one Rector. That's not bad.
We're going to learn about science pretty soon.
You think you can sack the Rector?
I do need a sack outlet.
Yeah, three cards in hand over there.
Yeah, he says, looking at the one in his hand.
Yeah.
I would love to have a sack outlet in my hand. I'm going to be straight with you, but...
Now we have to ask, is he good at playing the game? Is he lying to me so he can do it, or is he just an honest individual?
If you can answer the Rector, do it. Let's skip the mind games here.
You should destroy it, is what I'm recommending.
Let's not.
I will not put an Omniscience into play, I swear.
All right, I made up my mind. Wait, you're going to get Omniscience? Oh, maybe I haven't.
Wait, are you thinking of killing it?
I can't kill it, no.
Okay, don't kill it.
Yeah, never kill it.
That is objectively the incorrect thing to do. If you exile it, by all means do.
No, I can't do any of these things, but...
Oh. I'm super excited to see what this possible turn one play is, because this is...
I'm just going to give it up. I'm just gonna let the Academy Rector do its thing and be sad afterwards. That's how we're gonna do this.
Oh no.
Right, this is what I was thinking about.
Did you keep a no land hand?
No.
But the,
I was trying to figure out what to imprint.
Obviously, yeah, very, very
important. Okay.
If it's the Sword to Plowshares, I'm gonna be so mad.
Yeah. It definitely is.
It was this.
Oh wow.
Oh.
Yeah, that's
oof.
I mean, coming from the guy that drew over 120 cards last game, that's pretty... You even have the mana to cast it.
That's what I'm saying.
Must have something better.
Turn one Najeela is pretty hot.
Najeela, which is like kind of broken.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
I didn't even think about Opposition Agent. I'm just sitting here with a fetch land like an asshole.
Well, that was my decision, was pass with Opposition Agent up and turn off Rector or...
Yeah.
Najeela. I think Najeela's better, but I'm not sure.
Yeah,
for the record, my deck is playing Jeweled Lotus, Mana Crypt, Mox Diamond, Soul Ring, and all that jazz. I just got these dorks. Am I wrong to keep a dork hand in CEDH? Is that stupid?
No.
It just feels so unbelievably slow.
It's a lot better with like Timna, because then you can just go like land dork Timna on turn two, and then Timna starts drawing you cards. And then you can usually like represent Selvala
draws
like...
my opponent's cards.
Yeah, well, that's the thing, is you're not playing the good commander, yeah. Right? I don't even think Selvala is that bad. I don't know how sold I am on the build.
Yeah, I've got another Staxi piece in my hand that just, again, feels bad. Counterintuitive.
There we go, team.
Oh, baby.
Jamble. Is this for swords?
This opposition agent would have been so good.
Yeah, opposition agent would have sent me into the dirt.
Would have been gas.
Yep.
All right, so we've learned I should have just cast my opposition agent. Fair.
Yeah, probably.
But the turn one Najeela.
That's so funny, though, because the opposition agent feels, why is it more value? Because you would have only got one thing, and then everyone else would have just stopped casting stuff, right? So
yeah.
I guess you...
Yeah,
honestly, I do not care what he does right here with this stuff. I'm, like, the only thing that's going to matter is if the Academy Rector gets sacked or not.
But I guess you would also scare that if you let the fetch land go, let the gamble go, and then...
Gilded Drake is pretty good.
I went a little harder than Swords. Swords was my plan, then I saw the Drake once I got in there. I'll take a Rector.
Yep.
Not running the gambler and sitting on the Najeela. I see the second player in a row who gambles on the Najeela.
Yeah, just not worried about Academy Rector. Let's take that Nigella.
You have any sweet things you can get?
Yeah, I was gonna say collectively table.
Ishai has to have something, right?
I mean, there's the Smothering Tithe that I just learned as a 4 drop.
You could get Underworld Breach and go off too.
Yeah, I could get Breach. That's insane.
This is all very gross and I hate it.
Well, I don't have Omniscience, I promise.
Well, we can check your deck list, but I'm too lazy.
He does not. He has four enchantments. Mystic Remora, Underworld Breach, Ristic Studies, Smothering Tithe.
Oh, Ristic Studies, nice. That's better than Smothering Tithe, I think.
We established earlier, mana doesn't matter. It's card draw that's important.
Right. A Ranger Cap.
Are you should attack with that. Asmo Decahedron.
Oh, for sure, for sure.
Wait, can it get one or less, or just one?
It's one or less, yes.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not in your color identity, so that's not going to happen. But
wait, that's actually sweet that it can get Asmor, though. That's cool to know for Modern.
Man, just grab the combo piece anyway, even though you have it. Like,
the feeder. Yeah. Do you have a Homeward Path in the deck?
No.
That's not a CEDH staple.
It depends on the deck. Okay. Some decks play it. My deck does not. I'm trying to think. I think Nigella. Oh no, this is wrong. I shouldn't have done that. Can I?
Nope. Too late now. You're committed.
Yep. I should have held back a blocker for the Nigella, but it's okay. I can block with the Ranger Captain.
Yeah.
TLDR, we don't want the Nigella to get Warriors spinning.
Yeah.
That's a bad time.
No, you got. Don't worry about it. You guys focus on your own boards for a little bit and let Nigella just be awesome and do her thing.
The classic.
I could have been a little bit more proactive. Oh well.
Look at Nigella. She just looks determined and ready for action.
I hope you like to draw cards.
I do.
Hey, look at that.
Boss is like, do you want to come play some CDH? I'm like, yeah, I'll bring group hug. Like, what am I doing with my life? What am I doing?
I, like, genuinely considered playing Cody, but I also didn't want to, like, ruin everybody's days, so...
I won't lie to you, I know Cody's meant to be good, but I read it during spoiler season, and I now have no idea what it does, because it has so much text on it, I've forgotten.
Yeah, it's... You tap it for three, you make Wooburg, and then you exile cards until... Whenever you cast the spell for your next spell, you exile cards until you hit a card with CMC less... Instant or sorcery with CMC less than...
Oh, it has instant or sorcery cascade, doesn't it?
Yes. Yeah. And so you basically play no zero mana like instant sorceries, and then you just play like a buttload of one mana spells, and then you just like cascade into Profane Tutor. And then that gets you Bring to Light, which gets you Ad Nauseam.
Team, we did a pretty good job breaking this Nigella in combat. And I assume there's some removal spell, but... You can all block this thing.
I'm giving you an option here, my friend.
Me?
You don't block the Nigella, you block the Warrior.
No, you're fine. You can block... If you want to sack your Rector, you can do that.
Wow.
I'm not sure if I'm into this.
Yeah, this seems like a dirty trick. I'm probably just taking three.
I'm giving you the option.
No, you block the Warrior. Well, you don't let him get the Warrior.
All right,
It's a 1-1 versus a Ristic study. I mean, come on.
I will
block the Warrior.
I'm going to defer to Callahan's expertise here. Like,
wow.
Somebody who plays with Pongo, who is like the Nigella person, I'm telling you, you don't want the Nigella to get Warriors going, because that's how you lose the game.
All right, well, don't say I didn't do a nice thing. I gave you the chance to get a Ristic study.
You did. I appreciate it. Yeah.
I offered, and I was turned down. So say it.
I'll turn that down, too.
Oh!
I should have done this on the gamble in retrospect, but so here rude. We are, and...
I got a new plan then.
Yeah, but fun fact, Bosh was bluffing the whole time, Gilded Drake was in hand.
Yep,
got him.
Man. Uh-oh. That's pretty good.
Sorry, Commanders, maybe someday.
Well, I'm glad I opted to cast Selvala. It was my only option, because it's a body that could block the Jula. Everything else in my hand is either unable to block Nigella or just too disruptive to both me and everyone else.
Man, Selvala is thick. What the heck?
Yeah,
she's got a donk. For sure,
it's a 2/4.
That's bigger than a horn turtle.
this archetype. I guess a guarantee doesn't seem so hot in CDH because they're obviously some haymaker spells, but a lot
you
of
you know what commander I think is actually underrated that I couldn't find a list on, but could maybe be good in CEDH is Yasharn.
Oh, that does exist. Median MTG has a really good Yasharn list.
I couldn't find it. I was looking on that CEDH database. I was like, oh, Yasharn deck would be cool, but then I couldn't find one.
Okay. This is
Manifold, the best card on Magic Online.
Oh, ever. Yeah.
Yeah, the priority, like the thing that ruins priority.
Dude, I got really, I had to do like a 48-hour cube thing like last Christmas, and I was really tired, and I banned Manavolt. I got too sick of it.
Not taking
like
that one.
24 hours, it's like, no more Manavolt. We're not taking it. I'm sick of this card. Every time you play with it, it has 85 triggers, and it confuses you. It's not worth it.
Yeah, I've probably lost so many games trying to kill my clock more so than my face.
Exactly.
I will tell you, as somebody who plays a lot of CEDH, I have died to my mana crypt more than once. It is a non-zero number of times.
I died to my mana crypt in cube last weekend, where I had gotten Emrakul into play, the 15 mana one, and I was attacking for lethal with my opponent at 5 and no permanents in play, and I lost to my mana crypt flip that turn. Tough.
Steven Menendian in the Vintage Super League lost more than one important match to Rich Shea that was otherwise unlosable. To his own mana crypts.
Ouch. I know there was a game that in the MLC where I think it was Phoenix. It was like this long, drawn out game. He was on Hypatra and just ended up dying to his crypt.
That happens. It's not free.
Don't mind me. Just
making a billion mana.
Just
I'll have mana one day. God, I've never hated slow mana more than I have in my life than in this pot.
Are you going to activate Selvala and let us draw cards again?
I'm going to do it in people's hands so I get the card use first. Because I don't think I can monopolize on my mana. And last time I thought I couldn't either. So I'm not going to trust myself.
Well, it seems pretty reasonable.
I was going to say, that's all reasonable, but like, I want the
But
card.
You
want
to draw cards? Nah,
yeah, it's fine. Help me out.
You'll draw a 1-1 warrior by attacking Bosch again, I'm sure.
Yeah, Zach is down to 3 in hand. That's not very many. I only have 2.
That was a good one.
Oh, shit.
You needed a green source?
Oh, no.
You needed a green source?
I did need the green source, yes.
For what?
Well, it needed
Nature's Will is incoming.
Oh, no. Are we dead?
It's even worse!
Wow.
When it enters the battlefield or a creature you control deals combat damage to a player, you may tap or untap target permanent. That's scary.
Can he get there?
Full disclosure, I have no idea.
I don't know if you can't see. This is why blocking the warrior last turn mattered, because this might actually he might not be able to generate enough triggers.
Yeah, I'm with you.
I have no idea if this works or not. I'm just guessing. The spell in my
hand. The only person you could attack is Bosch, and I don't think you have enough triggers. I think you're like one short.
Is there something I can do here? Do I have any good creatures? I don't know what any of these do. That doesn't help.
Our out right now is Zach not understanding his combo. So I'm playing to it.
Well, I can get another creature, but I don't know if it helps me or not. I don't think it does. That one kind of does.
I mean, what if I have removal?
If you have removal, that would be pretty poggers. Not gonna
lie. It would, wouldn't it? It'd be pog and or champ.
Yeah, and he did pass the turn without leveling Tree Speaker and had the mana to do it, so representing something, whether it's there or not.
A Swords to Plowshares would be pretty hot right now, not gonna lie.
But if I had Swords and Plowshares, I could cast much. I have 2 white. I'm so good at this game.
Oh, nope. Just nothing.
Well, I love the big bluff there, just to get him.
Well, no, because like he can get Warriors, and I just Plowshares the Dereve before comp that damage.
Okay, that's fair.
Like, you can have him in a 1-1, it's the untapping that I'm scared of.
Yeah, he doesn't have enough triggers, I don't think. Because he can
also
get through.
Also, it may be that I haven't drawn any of my removals. There's also that. Yeah.
So you block the warrior, and then he gets 2. Yeah, he can't activate Najeela. No, he can activate Najeela once, I think.
So, 1, oh, 2. Alright, so it's... I'm figuring this out. It's black, 1 other color,
Nope, he's one
two short. Hit. Yeah, one short.
Yeah.
Which means he's a turn away, which is spooky.
Well, he's a turn away anyway, so I'm going to get my Rector on.
Yeah,
you two figure it out.
Yes, get that value.
That's incredibly...
Wait, are you blocking? No, you're blocking the Gila, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
That's greedy.
Whatever. You two figure it out. I'm not doing all the work here.
You should have blocked the warrior. God damn it.
Oh, yeah, I'm just...
Callahan even before. Told you. Callahan even told you.
Like, yeah, I heard him.
Like an omen speaker.
Whatever. You two are building up boards over there, expecting me to not trigger my Rector.
It's my time.
Oh, yeah.
Did I draw a card for him? Oh, what the heck?
I've activated Selvala. You've activated my trap card.
Oh,
ooh, I love it.
It's time to make an impact on this game.
This is great.
That isn't just giving people cards.
All right, I'm going to find it in my top four. Let's go.
Oh, God, don't do it to me.
He only has four enchantments. That'd be awesome.
You blocked.
It's upset. Can't even
use an Ajila now. All
right. I didn't have it.
I can't use an Ajila.
You can next turn. That's the issue.
What if I drawn you into Lotus Petal off that Selvala and somehow punted this game again?
That would be phenomenal. I'd be a big fan. That would be an appropriate ending.
Because every game I'm just like, oh, I shouldn't have done that. But like, level up should be instant speed. Absolute cowardice. Yep. If level up was a mechanic designed in the modern development landscape, it 100% would have been instant speed.
Yeah, probably. Though Outlast is pretty close to level up, and that's also a sorcery.
And that also sees no constructed play.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, I say that Jiraga does see play like in cEDH and I guess Canlander and stuff. That's probably the closest level up comes to.
Yeah.
It's obviously in cube too, right?
Cube God.
And seven level up card, the white one drop.
What's the Student of Warfare.
Yeah, exactly.
Coral Helm Commander saw Legacy play for a while. There was a golden era.
Is that the extra turns one?
No, that's the Merfolk. It's a Grizzly Bear.
Lord, right.
Yeah, Grizzly Bear that turns into a 3/3 flyer and then turns into a Lord / Air Elemental.
But Blue just kept getting better aggressive creatures.
Yep.
Right?
Yep. Oh, Merfolk, Swords of Plowshares and Terminus did bad things to Merfolk.
Oh, of course. Oh, I see what you mean. Sorry, it was played on Merfolk more so than like blue tempo decks.
Yeah,
I actually don't think I could deal with the Sturevi now that there's an Aven Mind Sensor.
Sucks to suck.
Are you saying you're gonna try to deal with the Aven Mind Sensor or the Sturevi?
Do you want to know a fun thing? I took Palace Chain out to put the Finale back in.
It would be great here.
Yeah, I could even shoot it for next turn. But
you said you were gonna try to deal with the Aven Mind Sensor.
I mean. I could have, but I can't now.
Okay, so you're gonna let the Derevi live. That's what we agreed upon.
No, I'm gonna I'm gonna take that Derevi and I'm gonna throw it in the bin if I can.
Man.
Alright, I see how it is. I see how it is.
I should not have cut that Palace Chamber.
I've got a pretty savage plan here. I'm excited for this.
Is your plan to turn Najeela sideways and win the game easily?
No. Well, that might be involved in the plan. That part may or may not be. The rest of the plan is what I'm here for.
Let's reset this with a wheel. What do you got over there?
I would love to if I could, but I'm going to try my best to... Oh, I can't even do that! God damn it!
Oh, no.
Aven Mind Sensor is screwing me up so hard.
You have a chance.
That Ranger,
you get to see four.
I literally shit myself. I'm like, what's going to happen now?
Yeah, he's going to look at his top just, four.
Me punning really hard.
Narcomancy?
Oh.
Yep.
Narcomancy? The power of sleep.
Yeah, that's a different card.
You can control dreams. Narcomancy.
Alright, we're going off. Top four cards. Oh
my god. This is a combo.
Wait, yeah.
Is it?
No, it's not.
Okay.
No, yeah, not even a little bit.
What were you going to get that could be in the top four? Come on, tell us before you hit it.
Well, I it wasn't even that. It was me just like being like, oh, I could do this and like try and like for some reason my brain was like, oh, you'll be able to search off of this and not Aven Mind Sensor. And I'm just four lands.
If we upshift Aven Mind Sensor to rare, then maybe it'll get the extra power and toughness the opposition agent has, but not all the other upsides. Am I right?
Yep.
Probably.
Yep.
I said I wasn't going to moan about it all video, but here we are.
With you.
I think we are just dead to Zach.
Again. No, we can do this. We can do this.
You guys are good. You guys got this.
Bosh, do you have anything? You have mana up.
I got something.
You have three entire cards.
What?
Here's one.
What does that do?
That's... to do anything.
That just means that I can't draw you, myself, and Callahan into more action.
No, you can draw me an extra card, and I get three extra mana.
You've just killed us all, I think.
No, I've just made me the only savior.
I think you've just killed the table.
Nah, we got this.
Why the fuck did you do that? The fuck are you doing?
I'm also confused.
I really need a collector who forgets to turn that fucking chrome box off, don't I? But
it wouldn't matter anyway, because he could just point all of his untaps at the
and then tap it and the untap resolve and
and he's at enough life now that it does, or yeah, it just doesn't matter because you gain life off Najeela swings after that. It gives him lifelink.
Got it.
Wow, it does. That's messed up.
Yeah, Najeela's a really broken magic card. Like, it should not exist.
What?
It's almost like if they keep putting, like, just adding words to a card, eventually you get to a critical mass of it being too good. Like, why does it have lifelink written on there? Why?
Why is it five colors? Like, it just, there's so many question marks with this card.
Yeah, trample. It's a 3-2. It could be an X one. It could be a 3-1. They could have done anything. It's wild.
Yeah.
So, serious question, and maybe I'm just dumb, but if Najeela unloads on me and, like, kills me and gets infinite combats on me, it's going to have to turn on the other people eventually, right? And Najeela will have to keep connecting to keep getting combats.
Yeah, he'll have a critical mass. Like, you only need one person. Yeah, because you only have to, once you connect through, it like doesn't just give you one per every combat. It doubles every combat that you swing.
Right. Also, Najeela doesn't need to attack to make the 1-1s. She needs to attack to untap.
Oh, it's whenever a warrior attacks. Got it.
Yeah, okay. So Derevi is the problem. If we could block a Derevi.
Figured it out.
No, yeah, you have to block the Derevi.
I can't draw any cards now.
You don't have to do anything to Derevi. That's fine.
Yeah, Bosh, you completely took me out of being able to do anything. Should have leveled up my Jiraga to cast that, but I was too busy being tilted. let's play.
No, you can still give me a card, and I can answer it.
I'm gonna have to, aren't I? Otherwise, we just lose.
Yeah.
My
plan was to become the hero that we all needed.
But now I'm tempted to just not bother, despite you.
Yes, I like this plan. I'm with it.
I will tell you, my hand is Imperial Seal, Finale of Devastation, and Mental Misstep. And what I was going to do on last turn, if you didn't put in the Aven Mind Sensor, was get a Gilded Drake to take to the Derevi.
Yeah.
That's clever.
And, yeah.
I was going to let the Vector survive, was I?
Oh my, that Hullbreacher is nice.
Yeah. Nice for you, Derevi Najeela person.
Wait, it doesn't even help me at all. It's helping him. I miss my card draw.
I've got Skull Clamp in hand. I've got Selvala. It's just literally made us not be able to do anything.
I think Skull Clamp is a really bad magic card. Like, it's not good.
That's a take.
It's illegal on.
That is very interesting and completely wrong. But okay. Let's put the Fauna Shaman.
Yeah. You got a Fauna Shaman.
Yeah. And then I guess I'll just keep casting bodies. I mean, what's the worst that could happen? Play this fucking thing as well. Imagine having a combo to protect. Imagine seeing it. Right.
who would have that?
Right. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Bosh with my two. Oh, no, pass through. My bad. I was going to hit Bosh with the 2-1 to try and turn down the number of times that.
He has Derevi. He could just block it.
No.
Derevi's a 2-3.
Yeah, yeah. Hit me.
Bosh.
Oh. Okay.
For frustration. To lessen the number of times that you did. We're just dead, right? We're dead.
Yeah, we're very dead.
Hold on.
Yeah, hold on. Calm down. I'm gonna cast a silence first.
Me too. I have a mental misstep in hand, so
I'm gonna silence, and then you can misstep his silence, and then we can all see what my answer is.
Yeah, I'm gonna target his silence. I guess.
really clenching my butt cheeks here.
All right.
I've just shit myself. There's no tension anymore. My arsehole's given up.
All right. So...
what is happening? I'm so confused.
Well, this is good if Bosch has something, because now Nagina cannot do
it. It's great if Bosch has something.
Yeah.
It's unclear.
Zach has anything.
It is very unclear if he has something here.
Yeah, nobody knows.
I don't think this ends up working. Like, I know it doesn't.
I think you do have to swing Najila in order to make it work.
Yeah, and then I'm sad, so I can't replay her.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe that's the answer.
Does he?
Did I have a plan the whole time?
No.
It seems like he did.
He may still be able to get there because he has 3 untapped mana, and he can just swing Dan, Derevi, Warrior, get another Warrior.
You can expect to get 4 damage, right? Oh, no, but you won't have the untaps. Of course you won't. Yeah.
Yeah, I have to activate, so you have to swing those 3. So you'll get 4. Najila math is annoying. I gotta be honest with you. I just play Rector and try to win with Omniscience. Or, you know, Pattern of Rebirth.
You don't want to block the Dranith. From yeah? Yeah.
What's that?
You never want to block this Dranith, because it's probably helping us in some way.
Not hurting me at all.
Yeah, it that's not symmetrical.
I think you block the Warrior.
Yeah, you block the Warrior.
You don't want him to generate Warriors.
Because if he doesn't win this turn and we can deal with Najila, his own Dranith stops him from recasting Najila, right? Oh, no, his opponents!
Yep.
Yeah.
Modern card design, we were just saying.
Modern card design is so confusing, right? Because
so he gets a trigger. So he gets an activation, but I think that's enough.
Yeah, because everything that goes through Arena says your opponents, anything from Modern Horizons 2, like Solitude, allows you to shoot your own stuff, right? It's very clear which ones are designed for Arena and which ones aren't.
Right.
I remember when Dranith got, like, revealed. And everybody just, like, pinged Sheldon a billion times. Like, you need to ban this card, like, right now. I'm just like, I don't know that we need to ban it, but, you know.
Yeah, maybe just put removal in your deck.
I think we've also, not the people at this table, but as a community, we have created a culture of let's let everyone do all the things all the time.
Yeah.
Which doesn't actually work, because someone's got to lose. And also, there are loads of cards in Magic that affect your opponent doing things, because that's a way to stop people from killing you,
right?
So you can do things. But we have this unhealthy relationship with Magic where, like, it's like, oh, I hope your command deck doesn't make you have to apologize at the end of it, and stuff like that. It's just...
That tweet tilted me so hard.
Right.
I'm
not throwing personal shade at anyone in directly here, either. I'm just...
Yeah.
That whole attitude just bugs me.
Yeah.
But I've been very vocal about this.
Well, and it's the way I describe it is it's like, imagine playing Monopoly and then apologizing because your opponent landed on Boardwalk.
Yeah.
Like, it just, I don't know.
Like, EDH isn't Dungeons & Dragons. It is not, as much as we pretend it is not a cooperative experience.
Yes.
Like, it's a collaborative, but still a game that someone has to win at the end of it.
Right.
And there's also this illusion, this idea that we have to let games go on for 6 hours as well. It's like, you can just start again. I know shuffling is a pain in the ass.
Well, there's this weird tension because I posted on our Twitter like last week about like should planeswalkers be legal as commanders in EDH and why or not? Why or why not? And regardless of how you feel about that, what I kept hearing was it will make games longer. And it's so strange to me that that is an argument against it, because one of the things I hear all the time is that we like EDH because the games are long and we don't want games to end on turn 3. And then your argument against allowing more things to be commanders is, well, we don't want the games to go too long. And I'm just like, odd tension to me.
You really don't want the games to go too long. Long commander games that go like too long are awful. When you're in tapping for that third hour of the game.
Yeah, yeah. I'm a big fan of being able to switch up decks.
Let's play game
other things.
That's why I like CDH so much, right? Is because it's like games end like generally somewhere
before turn like 8, right? And so, and that's like a long game. And
wait,
so,
fuck. What happened?
Did we get another turn? Did we not?
I told you I had a plan.
Your plan was literally just use Hullbreacher twice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you fumble into that, or did you? Is that? Did you plan all that?
No, I was one mana away.
Yeah, and he was a mana away. I mean,
wow,
that had to work. But I had silence and a counterspell to keep any mana rocks out of the play. But like, the math to get another turn was there the whole time.
Wow.
You don't get another turn if I don't cast my own silence. So I screwed that up.
Drannith
you did mess that up.
Which is pretty pog.
Would a land drop not have made it?
A land drop would have killed.
Yeah, we have to fade land drop, and silence
and
actually
no random
up.
Silence, right? Yeah, I'm with you.
No, it's very refreshing to hear somebody have that opinion. That's not me though, Vince, because like I feel like a lot of the time I'm yelling that exact opinion, and people are just like, "Man, that's such CDH bullshit," and I'm like, "Oh, okay."
I live in this very weird tension of people complain that my decks are too powerful, but then CDH players moan in my comments that I'm not a CDH player. So I'm just like, I'm a nomad who lives in this I hate the numerical scale shit too, but like in this nine area.
It's such a terrible way of
there's three different pods across GP Vegas where we agreed that we're meant to be playing sixes or sevens, and then my opponent makes a turn two Vorinclex, and I'm just like, wow, old Vorinclex as well. And I'm like, cool, nice six you got there, friend. Like, it's just such bollocks. But so I live in this weird tension there, but I also just believe that, like, I'm going to say this again, this is like videos coming up in the future, but we baby people. We really baby people. Whoa, oh, cool.
We are destroying the Najeela.
Bosh, I'm impressed.
Yo, chill out on the killing Najeela. She didn't do anything wrong.
I've threaded the needle. Now you guys need to pick up, because all I got left is this fucking commander. I mean, I know it's a big one, but like...
Just kill my shooter. I could have hoofed him to death if you don't kill my shooter. What are you doing?
Well, I don't want to die either.
It's completely reasonable.
If you got rid of the Aven Mind Sensor, I might have been able to deal with the Derevi too.
Absolutely not. This Aven Mind Sensor is keeping everyone in check.
Oh, for sure.
It's making you honest.
I definitely had the option to remove that and chose not to.
Let's see.
So, to finally finish my point, we just need to stop babying people, and it's okay to try and get better at the game. Like, whilst we're on rants, the word casual is the weirdest word that we use to describe shit in this game.
Oh, that's like, draw.
Oh, I'll shut up now. I'll let you talk your stuff.
Oh, no, sorry. I just drew an interesting card.
Does it tutor in your deck, like the rest of your hand?
Yes, actually.
Well, if you fire off all three of them, one of them's bound to hit.
Right? That math tracks.
That's just math.
Yes. You get... That's just, it's 50-50,
it's
really,
like looking at 12 cards.
It doesn't...
Yeah, it either works or it doesn't.
Try and play Timna and see if I can draw cards. Because I think that's the only way I'm getting out of this.
I love that he got so excited about it. He's like, oh, I just drew it. Wait, even my sense.
Yeah, no fun zone here.
Yeah, that's...
I sacrificed my beloved Hullbreacher, so you all can have turns.
Oh. If I swing Gilded Drake at you, will you block with Aven Mind Sensor?
No.
Okay, that is... I'm literally just trying to draw a card.
Zach doesn't have any blockers, and he's a big scary threat.
Yes, but I want to try and draw two cards here.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, you're going to attack Zach anyway, I get you.
So, Gilded Drake there. Yeah, I wanted to swing at something at Vince that could connect. And we'll swing that there, and that seems good.
Question is whether I trade in Jiraga, True Speaker, and Grand Abolisher to lessen the card draw for Callahan. It's two mana, and... No, it's not happening. Right? You got one mana. What's the worst that can happen?
Yeah, I don't know. And it here, guys.
Flies. How do I forget this fucking thing flies?
Three cards in my hand that tutor and Aven Mind Sensors in the air, and I just.
Yeah, spoilers. I can't block it with two ground dudes. So or dudettes, should I say.
Okay. We are going to attempt to draw cards and hope. So happy that Hullbreacher is gone. What are the guys? Okay, I'm gonna tell you what's in my hand because it literally doesn't matter.
It might give me an erection if they're all tutors. Just be careful.
You know, there's two tutors in my hand. I've drawn this turn, Protean Hulk, Omniscience and Elvish Spirit Guide. Can somebody send help?
Hey, don't worry about it, because I already stole your Academy Rector.
I was going to say, Najeela's on the way to help, man. Don't worry.
Najeela will end your pain quickly.
Just cry. I'm so sad.
Derevi is still alive. What is going on?
Yeah, Derevi is still in play. Vince has quite a board there. Like,
don't worry about
everyone could draw cards. There we go.
Alright.
Oh shit.
What?
He just went off.
Can you untap the what's it called? The your Selvala on what's his name's on Zach's upkeep?
Why?
Like, would you be able to activate it again in this next turn cycle?
Why?
The reason is I top decked a Noxious Revival, and there is a world where we can keep Zach off of Najeela a second turn in a row, and then allow Bosh to land Jeska a third time and kill the Derevi.
Noxious Revival do?
There's also a good chance that PK can just win right now. Look at this board. There is. Look at this board. That works too. Yeah.
That will also do it. Gotta tell ya.
How does that do it?
It stops you activating the Najeela.
Yep.
That's kinda rude.
I probably should have sequenced this better. I should have done some card draw first, but
I'm
too excited. I haven't cast a Limbala in like 2 years. This is exciting.
Yeah, that's a great card.
It is.
Let's make this mana and this card. Mana.
I'm thinking it's a little rude.
Let's play this terrible magic card.
Oh, it's real bad.
Yeah, it's abandoned everything for no reason.
Oh, I'm really a tit. Because you asked me questions. Not blaming you, Callahan, but I should have used my Birds of Paradise and not made the land drop. I even thought to myself, what if I draw Cradle here? Never mind. Derp.
I was trying to politic.
If I do draw the Cradle, I pretend I didn't. Sorry, don't look like such a twat. Right. What we got, Deck? What we got? Show me what you have.
Show me what you got.
No, I'm pretty sure it's show me what you have. I'm almost certain. This is shit.
That's because
Skull Clamp sucks.
Yeah, maybe Skull Clamp is a bad magic card. I'm going to draw like 6 to 8 cards and be very upset that they're all shit, aren't I? Come on, Skull Clamp. Also, don't show me that the sequence of Vala was terrible. Okay.
It's very ominous as somebody who's watched your videos and heard you make this commentary like live to hear you say that.
What? Did you still claim your Priest of Titania? What?
I've bricked so hard. I just want some gas. Come on.
All right.
Oh, that's pretty gas.
Yikes.
Oh, but it's so close to being gas, but it's not gas. What the fuck?
Is that like oil? Yikes. Like crude oil?
Hey,
it's like almost gas.
I see what you did there.
Yeah. I had to contribute something.
Who's oil?
Well, we've got like one comedian and then like three people who play like competitive magic. So like...
Hey, I played competitive magic once upon a time. Not very well. And it's fucking hand. Right, let's go with this.
Yeah, that's a sweet one.
That is a good magic card. See, the thing is, we can't really respond to anything because of that good old Grand Abolisher.
Yeah, that's
not like it could do anything anyway.
I'm just F6'd and watching the show. Like, let's
go. I'm scared of the Ishai. Like, so at the moment, playing another spell, you can hit me for what, 18?
You have a blocker.
Yeah, but
you have two blockers. Do I have two removal that I didn't point at Najeela over the last two turns?
That is true.
I clearly don't have removal.
Yeah, if
it's literally just doing nothing, just hanging out.
How big will Ishai get?
If you guys make it big enough, I could one shot Zach probably. Just get him out.
That is an interesting.
Don't give him.
I think it's big enough right now. TBH.
Don't give him the 3-0 of this pod today.
That is also a thing I do not want to happen. Yes. Let's say my sense is doing God's work, so I can't let it go. Go, Ishai. Go forth and clap Najeela's cheeks. Sorry, Josh. I guess I should equip the Skull Clamp to the Limbala in case it dies, I guess. That's clever. Look at that. Look at this. There you go. I did second main phase as well, which is the pro play.
Nice.
Is it not good?
I'm not saying it's bad. I don't know.
The way you said "is it though," it sounded like you had a follow up.
Oh no, I'm just like genuinely wondering. Like, I don't know, like, what the correct play is there. I don't play with Skull Clamp enough. I don't play Cole.
Well, so Josh wants Linvala dead. So if he has a kill spell that's not exile, that'll draw me two cards. If I end up having to block an Ishai, it'll draw me two cards. It's a lot of upside. But also, I don't think Bosch wants to attack me and have Linvala die, because that would then turn Jilla back on. Bosch also being super quiet and talk about how he has all these plans, so I'm assuming he's also just gonna...
No, my plans are over. Najeela can't come into play this turn unless he has a land drop, which he didn't have last turn. With the sphere makes it cost 6.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Oh wait, no, there's a soul ring there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can count. Alright. Najeela can arrive, but that's it.
Go Najeela.
Ooh.
Breach them halls.
That's pretty good.
God.
Okay, well,
I still have nothing.
That's all right. Nobody thinks you're the threat right now, which is a great place to be in a game of EDH.
What actually was the best white card in Commander Legends? Was there any?
I don't think there were, going to be straight with you.
Just none.
Was it Court of Grace? Like,
Court of Grace is busted.
Oh, right. Yeah, that seems to make you play, right? Yeah, okay.
I've seen some people do like a Chroma Sakashima decks, which are kind of cute, not gonna lie, but it's blue-white, so like, how good can it really be?
That whole bunch means I can't Skull Clamp anything next to him.
Damn straight. See? Skull Clamp, terrible magic card. Confirmed.
Yeah, you're right.
I am being attacked by the Drevi. Interesting. Guess it doesn't really matter, because...
You're dealing without a flyer.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it would be not very smart of you to swing your Drevi into a 10-10 Ishai.
I would block, yeah. I promise.
That is why I did not do that.
Yeah, tapped out under Sphere of Resistance. I'm not gonna fall for the bluff.
Yeah, the Sphere does stop the Simian Elvish Visionary Mutagenic Growth to a Battle Rage line, right?
Yeah, I mean... two of those three things you just said grow Ishai.
Yeah, but I'm just saying that, you know, they can't possibly have it.
Hmm. Oh, is Ishai just gonna hang back? Is that possible?
Trying not to die.
Yeah, this Birds of Paradise just eating up this damage here, and yeah, I guess I should.
You can't even recast your commander. Man, that sucks.
Yeah, she costs more. I guess I can at least do this. Feels good, man.
Wow. Lotus Petal gets infinitely worse at one mana.
Look, you just paid one quarter of the Smothering Tide cost for like 1/7 of the value at minimum.
Yeah, it's fine. That went well for me. All around, not bad.
Man, I just wanted to make Vince proud and do Rector Fit stuff.
You tried.
I'm just trying to actually have an effect on the game besides making somebody win.
Okay. That's I feel like I've
stopped people winning more than they've made them win this game, so I guess I can tick that off my bucket list.
There you go.
Is it another tutor?
No, it's not. That if it was another tutor, you would know. you would be very aware. I think it's just gonna be a Thrasios, because I want dudes, because it feels like dudes are gonna be worth having in this board state.
Yeah, this game is starting to slow down into like a really kind of fun way.
You mean into a wait until you have 5 or 6 mana and can cast your Jeska and yeet us all into oblivion?
That's not even how this works. Like, the second I go for Jeska to kill one of you, the other two of you just crack me back. And, like, I have to politic this a little bit. And I don't even think I'm the threat yet. Like, I think we're still pretty close with Zach, and he has the Hullbreacher, and, like, we're a twist... Sorry. We're a wheel away from.
I don't even put my name in this. I'm really far away, dude. I mean, super far away.
We're a wheel away from that not even being true. And then PK's got all this sweet stuff going on.
He is.
I'm gonna be honest. I don't even know if my deck has wheels in it.
I don't know either.
I don't think it actually does.
I think a lot of, I actually think they don't. I think they play Hullbreacher as a hate bear most of the time.
I don't have a single wheel in my deck. I'm looking at this now.
Which, who made that list? Is it Pongo or is it Killstars?
Dude, I have no idea.
Well, look at the author of the list on the deck list that you downloaded.
It says Primer or Deco, maybe?
Oh, Deco?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the cEDH Brazil team.
Okay.
I'm like genuinely surprised that doesn't have a wheel in it. That seems like something he would play. Interesting.
I have no wheels. Ooh, Sylvan Scry.
Ooh, it's cradle time.
Yeah, there's gonna be some big stuff here.
Thing is, cradle doesn't really do anything.
What? They don't have like any way to untap it.
The reason it's not doing anything is they can't even try to draw cast the skull clunks, the bloody Hullbreacher. And losing my Aether Mind would be terrible. So I don't know if I want to do that.
I don't even know what my win is here anymore. I have two of my expensive pieces in my hand, and I'm not really sure. I don't have survival anymore, so I don't have a way to bin either of these things. So
I mean, the game's gone long enough that you're close to casting them.
Have you looked at my mana?
I mean, like, if you're take a turn untapping that mana vault, you can cast Hulk the following turn, or just if you have some way to untap vault. I mean, there are multi-turn lines here. Like, all of your easy ones are, I agree, your easy ones are gone.
Yeah. So I have to not only do that, I have to then deal with the Linvala and the Aven Mind Sensor.
Yeah, this Linvala is being kind of...
Or the Linvala is putting in work.
You could also just bide your time and possibly wait for one of PK to get killed.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of what I'm doing, right? Is I'm like kind of... What is... Oh, shit.
You're hitting my birds? Why?
You need to have a blocker for the massive Ishai.
Yeah, that's true. Get that out of here.
Three.
Yeah, that one's okay to go away.
That could have been a
rude.
That might have been better to go on the Ishai, not gonna lie.
And it's maybe still 13-13 up forest. Or is perhaps it not a creature?
Perhaps I have the answer to an Ishai. Ooh. That is not as good as letting the Ishai kill other people first.
Yeah.
Also, no, the bird is not a creature. I was very tempted to hit the Hullbreacher, but yeah, I don't know.
I was gonna say you could have hit the Hullbreacher and just got clamping.
Yeah, but no.
It's running out of creatures over there.
Anyway, so it's pretty clamping.
Yeah.
My sense is doing too much good work. I don't need any more cards if I can just cut up to my hand.
You have one card in hand, right?
Yep. And it's pure gas.
That's...
Oh no, what is this?
Another one.
He's got a mind sensor too?
This game is so delightful.
I've had an Eldritch Evolution in my hand since like turn one.
I teach you to play bad cards that aren't Skullclamp.
Yeah, Skullclamp's been going off just fine.
Dude, Skullclamp's trash. What are you talking about? Hullbreacher's making it awful. Sorry, guys. I keep like looking at my phone and then forgetting to pass priority. I'm the worst.
That does make you the worst.
You should throw your phone across the room until we finish playing.
Confirmed the worst.
Well, just put it in your pocket. Right, so you can cast Jeska.
She can arrive if I believe that is the right play.
It is 100% the right play. Josh needs to die before the Vala dies and we all die.
All right. I'm sold. Mini Z sell. Here she comes.
Giving the Timna deck the creatures is so lovely.
Yeah, I've been spreading it around. Spreading the love.
Hey, I haven't got one. You say spread it, you've given two to Callahan.
I'm pretty sure I've had all of them.
Yeah, and now you're giving one to Josh because he's going to die.
Yes.
So, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, I'm a benevolent god. All right, now I got to figure out what to do with this thing. This isn't as exciting as I thought it was a second ago.
I feel like killing the Derevi is probably worth it.
I mean, yeah. Oh,
no.
Let's let
Doretti just chill out for a little bit. This Gilded Drake is the only thing holding you back from killing him. Oh no, because
if the Doretti's dead, though, we don't have to live in fear of another Gila either.
Yeah, we don't. Because then you don't have to worry about the Linvala just going away.
All possibly true things.
Josh has got a removal spell. I can feel it in my bones.
Oh.
But it's a removal spell that doesn't hit Isha. It's going to be Lightning Bolt. That's my... I don't know what I'm... I was literally just partaking badly.
Just making noise for the most part.
I'm just very warm. Oh.
Okay. Those feel like solid targets.
What has my Bolasher ever done to you?
I couldn't mind censor your Sylvan Scrying last turn. That's what a Bolasher did to me.
And now I've got a Wywood Lodge? Yeah.
I know. It's bullshit.
All right, Derby's out of here.
I'm genuinely surprised that this game has gone on as long as it has.
Yeah, this has gotten scrappy. I will exact
this is
my
kind
revenge,
of like.
Though.
This is kind of how cEDH can be, where games like either, we were talking about this last night, where games either like are over by turn three or they tend to like drag on.
Yeah, it's a lot like Legacy, where like combo versus control decks, a lot of the time, like the control deck has to spew early resources to stop the combo deck's attack, and then both players end up with nothing, and whoever like cracks through the parity first somehow ends up pulling ahead, and it's exciting. Uh-oh. You feeding the Hullbreacher?
I don't like that we just made him three treasures.
Well, deal with him then. I've been asking you all to do it.
I told you what... I've been very clear what is in my hand.
Bosh could have killed him, maybe, possibly. Somehow.
No, I couldn't. He either had a blocker or I could triple Ishai, but I couldn't do both.
Well, you know what? That's a fine card. I'm going to be straight with you. Are we at the point where I start considering hard casting an Elvish Spirit Guide because it is a body?
Oh, fuck.
Have we reached that part of the game?
As a heads up, the weirdness that I just did was because I was just remembering the Sniffing Narset's text.
I figured that's exactly what was happening.
The strictly better text. What a load of shit. God fucking damn Hullbreacher. I was like, I'll get one card out of this. No, I didn't get shit.
Hullbreacher's a huge asshole. It's true.
So I apologize profusely to the entire room now.
Except for Zach.
Who, fuck.
He can thank you.
Still like an apology. I'd take it. I appreciate him.
All right, finish him off. He's a wise guy.
What? Go be gentle.
And if you play a bunch of creatures, you can destroy all those treasures you gave him.
Yeah.
Let's go here.
I can't believe I thought I was the Narset text. So I was like, oh, I can push you into dealing with a Derevi. I can not have to kill the Hullbreacher. I can net a card in your turn, net a card in Callahan's turn.
Yeah.
And now I'm just sat here like, no, the Hullbreacher's still alive. I can't net cards. This is garbage.
Yep. Yeah.
Fuck. Need to learn to read them magic cards, I think.
Oh, no. I want to stop. Oh, my God.
I'm trying to make it so that you can kill him next turn.
He has things.
It looks like it.
Arachnofog? What is this?
Is this Astrophy? No?
Nope.
Endurance.
Ooh. Endurance.
That's hot. Brand new card.
Wow, 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 wow.
Yeah, you. I thought you were going to try and like kill me by killing my flyer. I was like, I got Flash Reach Blocker. I'm going to be good. But no, that didn't happen.
So we're flashing in Endurance, huh?
Your 3-3 is getting so eaten. Sorry, bud.
I mean, delicious. That's fine.
And you can go out on your own terms, just sack it.
I can't. There's a Linvala.
Oh, yeah, get wrecked.
Ah, boom.
Oh,
and it has reach! God damn it!
Yeah, it has reach.
I'm getting rid of Vince's graveyard here. What? It's gone. It's gone! I'll hear no arguments about this. It's gone.
And by gone, it means in your library.
Yeah, I've shuffled it back, which may or may not be better. I don't know.
I mean, I don't want to draw any of these things, barring perhaps the Fauna Shamans. That's pretty legit.
Yeah, ripping the old turn 8 Birds of Paradise with Sphere of Resistance in play. Not the goal.
I can't fucking believe I just gave them the Geo player the treasures for no upside.
Yeah, that's one of those tilts that wakes you up in the night.
Black. What the heck? What was that?
Yes.
What the fuck happened?
I don't know, man. I just didn't even, like, I was in blocks and then it just, I don't know.
That's the out we were playing to. The Moto interface is always the fifth player in the game.
That's fair. Like, that's a tough out.
If I took this Wyward line now and I draw Hoof, I'm gonna shit myself with rage. The Cradle's only good if I, like, raw dog the Hoof off the top, right?
Well, do it. You can get annoying. The Hoof right now. Do it.
I can probably cast it anyway. I've got, like, 1,000 mana, but still.
There's a sphere in play. Remember, you're one short.
Yeah, you have 999 mana.
Hells never fails.
But a bitch ain't one.
Oh, it did fail. Fuck. Okay, what did I get?
Huff.
That's,
Huff?
Bad.
Shit.
Like, objectively not good. Okay.
It's Sorrow's Path.
It's definitely full of sorrow, and a path I have unfortunately taken. I guess I can do it at a later date, though. So I'm gonna pass the turn.
I like this.
Uh-oh.
Just gotta keep up my little fort over here. My little
this
castle.
Does not spark Warhammer joy. Turn.
In Magic, we create pillow forts. In Warhammer, we create castles. I know which one I want to live in. Pillow forts sound a lot more comfortable.
You could put pillows in a castle, though, right?
But then it'd be a pillow castle. It'd be,
oh my gosh. Are you really cracking this Arid Mesa into two Avonmind sensors?
Well, the second one doesn't matter. If he's cracking into one, he's cracking into both.
No. It's maths. You can only look at two cards. Then's the rules.
I mean, 4 divided by 4 is 1.
Oh, fuck. My maths was awful. I can't remember what Hullbreacher does exactly, and I can't do maths.
Fails to find a mountain or plains. Put it in the graveyard.
It was a good, you know, it was a good shot. But
hey, it was 50-50.
Yeah, 50-50.
I'm pretty sure you just gut shot yourself, is what I see.
Yeah.
Look, you didn't enable revolt. No guts, no glory. You have to go for it sometimes.
Yeah.
Are these treasures going to lose us the game, aren't they? And I failed my mission.
Now we're good.
The Derevi is gone, which is kind of relevant.
But what if he's Savine Reclamation?
Well, I would like to remind the class I do have a Noxious Revival.
He has 4 mana. Oh, you have Noxious to interact with that. Cool.
Yes. Cool. I do have some. I have 2 pieces of interaction. They're not great, but...
Shippin.
Who are these attacking?
Bosh.
It's gotta be me, right?
Yeah. You should totally block that Hullbreacher.
That is my plan. I promise.
I'm, like, sitting here like, yeah, that's probably how we don't die here, right?
Moto on my screen's out a bit of mad. The Endurance moved position on the board 3 times. I have no idea why.
Yeah, it's just leaping all around.
It's not moving anywhere for me. What the hell?
It's just showing off its stamina. It has a lot of endurance.
When they attacked it moved? Oh, wait.
Yeah. That's a lot of skills to move around.
All right. I have eliminated one of the
Avonmind sensor.
Yep.
The death of that 2-1 was pretty impressive.
Yeah, at the cost of Hullbreacher. We've had some heroic Hullbreachers in this game. Like, one of them kept Najeela from winning the game on the spot. The other just died for half of an Avonmind sensor.
See, Sheldon, this is why Hullbreacher is fine. You don't need to ban this card. It's perfectly fine.
Yeah, let it ride.
It's a good card for the format, right? Like, this isn't at all a toxic card.
We're good.
Hullbreacher is pretty heinous, man. I don't know. This card's horrible.
Like, why is it not white? I'm sorry. I know I've said it up for like 8 times at this point, but I'm not going to stop. I'm going to stop till Bosch's comments are filled with people saying, why did that fucking Vince not shut up about white? But fuck me, it should have been a white card.
It does feel, at minimum, a blue-white card, right? Like, it just...
Why is it a Merfolk? Why is it Picture of Order, Force of Will?
Yeah.
Fuck all these things.
All right,
I mean, in all fairness, it's not really played that much alongside Force of Will, so it's not really a point, but it still pisses me off.
Swords on the Endurance fucking...
Can I respond to this? How many spells have been cast this turn?
One.
One?
Does it's Overgrown interesting. Tomb... Oh, you have Treasures. I was going to ask if Overgrown Tomb cast Flusterstorm.
Going out strong.
All right. That's actually pretty
this
good.
This is great.
Why?
I have something here.
The Noxious Revival? Yeah!
Oh, wow.
Are you flustering my fluster?
Oh, no.
I am.
You needed to let his trigger resolve.
No, it already did. It's already on the stack.
No, his trigger to make an additional fluster. Now I have to pay one.
Yeah, why did you bluster my bluster? You already had to pay. It literally just doesn't even make sense to do it.
Get him. No.
You're just giving him mana for no reason, and he's still gonna kill me. It wasn't gonna change.
This is politics.
Alright, fair enough.
Guts go off.
What is happening? This stack got really messed up. I don't know.
I wish I had a Fluster Storm to add to all this.
Did we Fluster Plow? No, okay. That would have been the...
I did not misclick.
The master. It would have been a masturbator there if tricked me.
If you would have Flustered Plow, that would have been cool. The game would have kept going now.
Well, the game's still going, just not for you.
It would have tapped.
I've been Kingmaker, or King...
Yeah, made. I want to unmake you.
Well, you're still going to have to pay one. Because
I know.
Weapon. Yes. Get him.
Brutal stuff. Oh,
baby, I'm paying one.
I basically just made it so that you don't have to pay two.
I still have to pay two because he can pay for your Fluster Storms with his treasures. Yeah.
I got rid of his treasures. Listen, I'm trying. I'm trying
anyway. What? Did nothing change?
Yeah, that was mostly just the for funsies Fluster Storm.
All right, fair. The I want to kick you while you're going out plan. I can go with it. I can respect it at any rate.
This does one that just doesn't win three games in a row, which is nice.
That's fair.
I mean, but now we're in a position where if I attack, I'm dead on board. So maybe I just...
Interesting. Yeah, I think maybe we just stay back. Just play defense for a little bit.
I think I might, wow. Honestly.
Right. I'm with it. I can get behind this.
I'm pretty sure I can kill him, given that you've removed the Endurance.
I haven't.
Because his only blocker is Najeela.
Okay.
So I should be able to swing some dudes to deal some damage.
All right, he's going to gain 3 life, though.
That's fine.
Sweet, sweet life gain.
Alan, have you gone from looking at your phone to eating on mic?
Oh, you can hear that?
Are you eating now?
But I could tell you were chewing when you spoke. And I was like, this guy. This Fluster Storms for no fucking reason. Looking at his phone.
Just eating cereal.
What are you eating? Tell the comment section what you're eating right now.
Yeah, they pretzels. Need to know, dude.
Pretzels. Like soft pretzels or like hard small pretzels?
Well, if they were soft pretzels, you wouldn't hear them.
Well, I can tell there's food in your mouth. I wasn't sure if you were sucking your own thumb or if you were chewing.
No, I haven't eaten today, so I was like just snacking.
I mean, it's not my video, so you know.
I tried to mute, but I didn't do a good job, so I'm sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, to be fair, this game has been going for 1 hour and 10 minutes right now, after the first games took a total of like 16 together.
Yeah.
Look, Callahan, you're never going to get a better shot than right now to attack Bosh and get him out of here. This is it. This is your opportunity. This is your moment.
17 life and a big-ass dude. I can't get
this
through.
This is your moment. Get in there,
dude. In the words of Martin McCutcheon, this is your moment.
Yes.
This is your perfect moment.
You can eliminate BoshNRoll from this game right now.
I have given you so many spirit tokens.
I just want to acknowledge that even if the Ishai did not exist, I mathematically do not have enough power on board.
What if I draw you a card?
Yeah, what if he draws you a card?
Yeah, draw him a card.
Still don't have enough mana.
I think maybe we should recount.
I think you should just crush Zach. Block the 3-0, and then the rest of us duel this out like adults.
No, let's get... This is shy as a problem. You need to be proactive about it. You need to
get that thing eliminated. Wait, I didn't want to exile it. I wanted to cast my Elvish Spirit Guide, because that's where we have gotten to in this game. Nice.
Make my monster grow.
For one moment, Callahan, you're complaining it's a 1717, 1818, then you make it a 1919.
It's like you don't even want to attack
Callahan.
Me.
Callahan.
Were you even allowed to exile it from your hand with Linvala in play? You aren't, right?
No, you can.
Yeah, because it's a creature card, not a creature. Oh, okay. And he doesn't control it.
Sure.
Huh. TIL.
Yeah. There have been some good rules lessons in your hand.
Vic, ship it. No!
Fire in.
No!
Remember?
Callahan could smell blood over the smell of his pretzels.
the classic smell of blood and salt.
That's not enough.
It's not.
What a good attack. I like
that. But it will do this, something? It will do this thing called draw me two cards.
Oh no, we're going to get Nijeeled. I guess we need all hands on deck.
Why can't I block the spirit?
Yeah, but I'm swinging two spirits at him.
Am I not allowed to block them?
No, the spirits aren't at you, they're at Bosch.
No, they're both at Bosch.
Oh. I just clicked straight through blockers then, because I assumed they were all going at Zach.
No,
that was a really sneaky attack. I appreciated that.
Oh, okay. No, I didn't click through blockers. I just lost track. But okay, I will block one.
Yeah. I like assumed you would, but I'll draw a card, which was...
It was your own Skull Clamp, right? Lose a 1-1, draw two cards?
I wish.
So, most overrated
card... You just did. You killed a 1-1 and drew two cards.
Oh, yeah.
Most overrated card in Vintage Cube by far. Skull Clamp.
If we're contextualizing it, yeah. I mean, in Cube, it's not the hottest thing, is it?
Well, it's also kind of bad in Commander, but I'm going
to... Says the guy who's going to lose. I shouldn't say this, because that means I'll probably lose now.
Yeah, you're talking shit. You're going to flip your mana crypt 11 times and die.
I mean, I'm on 42 life.
You're good over there.
Right then, let's go ahead and do some stuff.
Oh, that's a card.
I did not, in fact, draw a card. Well, I drew kind of a card.
Oh,
that is spooky.
Yeah, is it cradle time?
What is on your board?
I kind of want to draw as many cards as I can, so I'm wondering if I get a Horizon Canopy. But I put it in.
Wow.
I need to draw more gas than this removal spell. So I'll untap with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 mana. So I don't need a cradle. This is probably wrong on some level.
I respect any effort to draw more cards. Anytime.
I mean,
by anyone.
Like, I'm kind of also known for playing Cradle and having people complain that it's too good and it needs to be banned and all this shit. So it's funny that I'm over here like being like, maybe I don't need a Cradle.
Well, this is cEDH, so you're allowed to win.
Yeah. Oh, baby, that's a good draw. Now, how much counter magic do you lot have?
Fuck around and find out.
That's the attitude.
That's a 2020 Ishai. That's insane.
Yeah, it doesn't even need Jeska to be commander lethal anymore.
Yep.
But Nijeela's hiding over there. Don't forget.
Nijeela has been under pressure all game.
Oh, Nijeela is shit. Have a 3-3.
Yes.
Wow, you're targeting my thing with your thing.
Oh, I love this. I love this so much.
You could have killed Josh.
I want to marry I love this so much. I want to marry this moment and make a bunch of tiny little moments out of this.
Yikes.
Oh,
interesting.
Where's that going to go,
Kill the Avid Mind Sensor! Get rid of it.
Fuck off.
It's time. It's time.
Slowly my whisper, Avid Mind Sensor. Fuck off.
Or the Linvalo.
Oh my god, there's more things being Oh my goodness.
Oh, we're dispelling this. Okay.
Yep. I want that Ishai to go away, please.
All right. Interested in losing to Nijeeela again.
I don't think we're losing to Nijeeela.
Wow, Bosh. Yes, I'm bringing Nijeeela into this. Ishai's the threat here.
Have some faith there, Bosh.
All right.
Has everyone used all the interaction now?
Yes.
Good. I'm going to untap and cast this hoof.
Can you draw us a card first, though?
No.
Please?
If I do that, I probably don't have lethal. Like, I haven't done the math. I've got to do the math, haven't I, unfortunately?
Yeah, it's kind of required.
I think you should probably kill me. At least just try to draw one card.
Oh, it's on my turn? You did that on my turn?
Yep.
Yep, your end step.
Oh, yikes.
Yeah, yep.
I'm just going to bend this Protean Hulk, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
But it's a 6-6. Or is it a 7-7? I don't even remember. It's a 6-6. That's powerful. Tails never fails. Let's go. I lost the third flip in a row.
That's
usually how that goes.
Okay, Bosh, did you bluff and you actually have more stuff in hand?
You know my answer to that. Fuck around and find out.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have so much mana. I don't want you to draw any more cards. So I guess I'm just going to... Oh, that involves tapping my wire with those, so I don't have a follow-up. Oh, right, maths-wise. I'll make a hoof. I just spend one on the sphere, actually, don't I? So I can only consider beast within my own sphere, but I was scared the Ishar within 2020 would, like, guarantee I can't kill you.
I'm going to have to let you. Selvala. Yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
The sadness.
Damn it.
Untap target elf. Let's go.
Oh, let's tap Selvala one more time.
Oh, only got one mana off that Selvala. That's big money.
Mm-hmm.
That didn't even make mana.
Nope. That's pretty bad.
That's not how you cast Crater Hoof.
I should have fucking blew up my own sphere. Bollocks. Shit, bollocks.
You just have to tap Selvala one more time. You'll be fine. This is the one.
This is the one.
This is how I lost the last game. Right, here we go. Oh. Okay.
Damn it, again, no!
Got some mana off that one.
12 mana. It's not enough to cast that and that. So I just cast the hoof and see where we land.
There it is.
This is big sad.
He wasn't bluffing.
2, 3, 4.
I have a force roll in my hand. I can draw a blue card and 3 draws. Okay. Darn it.
Bummer.
We're so close.
Ooh. It gets to blow something up.
Yeah, blow up the necromancy. Get rid of
your sphere.
We're going to. Oh, we can. We're going to end as we began, if this is the end. I don't even know if it is, but I'm going to blow up that chrome mox.
No, because
putting the position agent under originally.
The original Chromox art. That you can pull up that one.
Wait, what? Why that one?
Yours is the original Chromox art too.
It's the turn one play, wasn't it? I'm not gonna kill the Najila.
I should have kept the opposition agent. I screwed up. I didn't realize it was gonna be a 2-hour long game, and I need to get all.
Buddy, don't worry about it. How many games did I screw up? Right, I have so much damage here.
Yeah, that agent would have gotten like 3 cards in my first turn cycle.
That also would have made my Rector like big sad.
So I attack. I can't kill everyone here.
Well, let's focus on...
I have a 3-3 beast, thank you very much.
Let's focus on those two, and then you can come back to me later, because I'm already pretty low.
You're at 49, and I have a 3-3 beast. Everyone else has a board state.
Am I scared of Callahan?
He's been
bragging about his handful of omnisciences and Protean Hulks the whole game.
Yeah, I got nothing to do, but I will say that killing me here is actually probably correct, and you want to take me and Bosh out here, I think, actually.
So yeah,
I agree. Odds of, like...
wait. So Zach is over there with, like, Najila on board, a bunch of mana. Yeah. He's on next turn, and you want me to get taken out?
I can't do anything. I gotta hit... My hand's all lands in a force wheel that I can't even pitch to.
How much does Jeska cost you next turn?
Jeska, I think I've cast her... So I've cast it 3 times from the command zone, so it's plus 8? It's 11? Is that how that works?
Plus the sphere as well, right?
Oh, yeah. She's not coming down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 7 mana. Not even close.
You definitely want to kill me here because I play Thassa's Oracle in DC and Tomb of Pack. So, like, the odds of me just, like, ripping that up pretty high.
5, 8, 10, 12.
I don't think I can live through here. Yeah,
but I don't know if I can kill you and Josh then. How much stuff is you have? 12?
I have 3, 5, 6. Oh, I have to look at toughness. 5, 8, 10. Yeah, I have 12.
So I hit you for 26. That's only 14 damage. I literally cannot kill you. You're the person I can't kill. Okay.
That's unfortunate. So then I guess you have to
I could put everything into you, but that leaves the Najila alive. Because if I put everything into you, that is 19, 26, plus number 6, that's 32. Minus 12 is still not lethal. You're the only person I can't kill.
That's hilarious.
I think you need to kill Callahan and BoshNRoll.
I can't kill Callahan, Josh.
You can do it. You can find a way.
Right. Let's kill Josh, because then he can't talk. That's how it works. Like Among Us. I'm joking, buddy. Do I even need to attack with everything once? 3, 15. Let's go in for 16 in the air. Leave a thing untapped. Love life.
Patrick Sullivan would be sad that you're counting Crater Hoof damage. All in this context, it makes sense.
I know. I wish I'd killed my. No, because the Ishar would have really messed things up. So I think that's lethal for you lot. No, yeah, because you only have 2 toughness. Okay.
All right, time for sweet vengeance.
What have you got?
I'm giving Zach a blocker.
Yes!
We're back!
I thought we didn't Kingmake in this form.
We're back!
We had a discussion about you not killing me, and you did it anyway.
Yes. Kingmaking in this format is, like, pretty normal, actually.
I'm surviving a crater hoof attack.
I could have untapped the Selvala with the Jiraga, but it would have been more damage.
Alright, I have a Mystical Tutor I can cast, but I'm not gonna bother. I'm dead.
So the Mana Confluence is offline.
Yes. Dude, I have... My hand's still bad, too.
Yeah, I'm sure you're dead anyway, but I'm gonna make it away.
Dying, yeah, it's pretty good.
I have three...
I'm actually scared of Callahan, but I couldn't kill Callahan. It just wasn't an option.
That's what we like to hear.
Sure, whatever.
Oh, that was the sweetest Flash Spirit I've ever seen. That was dope.
Oh, it was on board and everything.
It's so good.
I didn't take into account the idea of Bosh being petty.
Oh, you don't know.
Oh, that
me
was
at
your
all.
First mistake.
I don't know if I can get rid of my own board state for the viewers.
The minus button over on the right side.
You can't do it on your own screen. You can shrink down your hand size and stuff to expand the screen.
Okay, I can make that slightly better for everyone. But I can minus everyone but myself. Alright.
Hear me out. I've got a win available to me here. It's gonna take a whole lot of luck. But I think today it's on our side.
I am honestly rooting against you, but I did want to make the play I could make on that turn.
That's fair. Still.
Are you Eldritch Evolutioning for one extra mana into this Aven Mind Sensor and praying?
Yes.
Yeah, go off.
Yep. Yes. If I hit Thassa's Oracle, you die. I have a Tainted Pact in hand.
Oh, that's great.
Yes, yes, yes.
You can't cast... Hang on, Pact is one, isn't it? No, Pact costs you 2 because of Sphere, and Thassa's Oracle costs you 3 because of Sphere, and you can't tap Mana Confluence?
No, I have enough. I can do this. I have exactly enough mana.
Do you? How?
Because My Eldritch Evolution, I'm using the 4 I've tapped here, and then I have Underground Sea, Scrubland, and Treasure to cast Tainted Pact.
Yeah, so...
Because it puts the card into play.
Oh, into play. My bad. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, we just gotta fade this Mind Sensor.
Alright, go on, Mind Sensor! Show me Thassa's Oracle!
Show me whoop the money.
Callahan could use the Noxious Revival to knock 25% off this line.
I actually cannot because I don't have a mana to do that.
Oh yeah, Linvala turns off death rate. And yep. your spirit guide's in play.
It is in play.
Alright, I don't think I have anything I can do. I'm gonna concede.
Alright.
Let you guys finish this as gentlemen in a one-on-one battle.
Alright, let's see if the line is there. I'm rooting for Pleasant Kenobi. But
I tried, man.
Thank you.
I mean, you've been an underdog this whole game, but...
That is not going to get there, I don't.
Yeah, I've been feeling for this green-white deck the whole time. It just functionally just giving us the rest of us cards to kill them with, and...
You know what?
That Hullbreacher turn.
If it means that, what is it, Donglord gets to get this win?
There is Donglord, yes.
Let's go, Donglord.
Yeah. If it means that, what was it, Donglord? Yeah. There you go, Donglord.
I hope that's just their last name, and it's not even a joke. Their name is just like Jason Donglord.
Just like,
it is an incredible
meet the
name.
Fockers.
I do enjoy Twitch chat when people subscribe and they just have ridiculous names. Redongulous name, should I say?
Yeah, every time I'm playing Magic Arena and I queue into someone whose name is like, you know, Jizzblaster 9000, I'm like, this person is obviously not trying to make the Pro Tour.
One of my favorite Twitch names that is a regular hit on my stream and on Goldfish and stuff is, and they sub as well, so it always comes up people read it, is Big Nips and Magic Tips.
Nice.
That is a name that I will never get tired of reading out loud. Because everyone in chat is always like, that's incredible. It's just, it brings joy. It brings joy.
That's
that
delightful.
Awesome name,
that's
right. Joy.
2-mana Pilgrim. Standard playable. I don't know.
I'm ready for Marshall Sutcliffe to announce, like, next round we have Paulo Vitor Dama de Rosa versus Big Nips and Magic Tips. Playing for the Pro Tour top 8.
Okay. I am playing to not die in this turn cycle.
That is your job right now.
That is currently what I'm going to attempt to do.
No attacks.
I hate that that trigger goes onto the stack even if I like didn't attack.
Well, it's so you can change the number 0 to 1 with one of the very, very cryptic commands.
Oh, yeah.
Right, let's... Oh, my... Ignore me. Just thought I had something I don't have.
Wait, cEDH uses the EDH ban list, right? So silver border cards are good?
Wait, what?
What?
If only they put them on Mojo. Oh, yeah. I'm on the flip.
They were legal for, like, a week, I think.
Oh, did they change their mind on that?
No, it was just for when that set came out. It was, like, a thing they did. And then they unbanned.
Oh, you're being like... serious, right? I thought you were like, doing a bit.
No, no, really. I thought that silver border cards were legal in Commander at all points. Or, like,
oh, God, no.
Since Unstable was printed. I didn't know that was a temporary thing.
Yeah, I would not play if they were.
yeah.
Wait, so I can't play my Earl of Squirrel and Chatterfang?
I mean, you can.
Rule zero.
Like, people right, will I'm, rule zero.
I'm playing Earl of, no, I'm playing Earl of Squirrel and Chatterfang. You can't stop me.
Form of the Squirrel.
Just Earl of Squirrel. He's the Earl of Squirrel, dude.
Yeah, it's a pun. It's fun.
Would you build a deck without your government bureaucrats? You need them.
Oh, God, Sphere Resistance. Oh, fuck.
Yeah, that card's been shit.
Fear putting in work for me. Gotta love it.
Oh, bollocks my asshole.
I don't really understand what that meant, but it sounded cool.
Oh, shit. Okay,
is it like that thing from Clone High that, like...
If I run out of mana, maybe I still have... Oh, bollocks. I was like, oh, I can do this. I can do this. Right,
survival of the fittest.
This is a magic card that exists. Does it resolve, though?
I'll let this resolve.
Cool. I'm going to discard one green channeler.
Okay.
You should find a Restoration Angel in Blink Crater Hoof.
Oh, that's sick.
There's another.
Do we have a... We have literally no flicker effects in this deck. Dong Lord, if you're watching...
You're not even playing Flicker Wisp?
I am fucking disturbed. I'm upset.
What?
I mean, outside of Crater Hoof, what are you flickering?
Anything that's about to get removed is good. Two triggers off Aura Shards.
Crater Hoof.
I guess.
The only thing you need to flicker.
Yeah. Okay. It's only
I don't
one.
Think... So I'm thinking of going Stoneforge into Umbral Mantle, equip. But I think I'm actually short of mana, because Stoneforge will be 3. Umbral will be 4. Yeah, I'm way short because of the fucking sphere. So I'm going to get Witness, which just feels dreadful. I'm going to activate Selvala, which is awful. Well, got some mana out of that. I'm going to cast the Witness.
You're going to get Crop Rotation back, get Gaia's Cradle, and go
that, ham. That is the plan.
Mm.
Oh, this Aura Shards is going to get shreddy too.
Does this resolve, Callahan?
No.
Oh!
Okay.
Oh, no dice today, my friend.
We're going to untap Selvala.
Yep. That is a thing that you can do.
Draw some more cards, make some more mana. Holy shit, that's in here? What?
Collect a roof.
Oh, there's just a pod in here, and I'm like, what the fuck does that do now? That doesn't do... What does that even do?
You could sack Mind Sensor for Restoration Angel. Oh.
No, yeah, if only.
Yeah, that feels not great. I guess that's even more reason why there's not a Collector Roof in the main list.
Oh, you haven't forced me to think more about what I'm doing. I really wish I had to take that Palace Shader out, my friends. The Palace Shader was pretty gas in this exact circumstance. Also, there's no second copy of Hoof or a way to reset it to hand.
Awkward. Is there a Mirror Entity and Wirewood Symbiote you can pick up the Hoof?
Oh, wow, yeah, that involves a lot of mana, but yeah, that is a line it can take. That's old school legs that you talked about earlier.
Yeah, yeah, go off.
Okay, let's pitch this.
Marwyn the Nurturer.
Grab a Quarian Ranger. That hasn't died this turn, has it, this game?
I don't think so.
No. I don't know. This game has been very long. I don't remember
it's
anymore.
It's been the longest game in the history of games.
See, this feels like a normal EDH game, not a cEDH one.
Let's get a Query Ranger. Play. Oh, no, I don't need to start. I've got this. What?
Yep. That. You got a Kurian Ranger.
Or shards him to death. Get him.
Pop that. I haven't bothered with the text. That's one of the ones that kills it when it dies, right?
Yep. I hope so. Committed now.
Yep, I have to sacrifice it.
Untap this. Return this.
Oh. It's waiting on
I'm
me.
You, buddy. Sorry.
Okay. I'm like very unfamiliar with Moto. Selvala feels a lot worse in 1v1.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. Pitch this birds.
Hey, that was back from Endurance.
Grab back Wirewood Symbiote. Where are you, my friend? Where are... There you are. Cool. Make the double green. Make a Wirewood Symbiote.
Yep.
You have no flyers, right? Plan.
I do not have flyers.
Cool.
Yep, that seems like a good target.
Right. I was trying to do it like actual kills, but you were like, no. So I guess I'm going to have to do the old school, like, just hit you a bit.
I was going to say, aura shards plus flyer control.
It's just limited magic here.
If you could group block down my creature hoof and kill it, I'd be very grateful.
You know, I think I'm going to pass on doing that, but thanks for the offer. I greatly appreciate it.
Dude, he doesn't want you to kill it anyway. He can't even get it back at this point. His witness is gone.
Finale of devastation, baby!
Oh. I was going to say it's a sick bluff on your part to force damage, but no. Finale of devastation makes sense, I guess.
Go on. Pew pew. It's all relevant. It's all relevant, Callahan.
Oh god, Mana Vault. Just making things be awful, as always.
Yep.
Just ban it. Ban that, ban Delver.
Okay.
Ban that to Wolf Wars moaning about in one of the games jokingly. Ban that as well. Just ban everything, right?
If we... Yeah, ban Draenor's Magistrate. Come on, Sheldon.
And the Mirror. The Mirror. Everyone wanted that ban, didn't they? Early in the previous season for Bonfires 2. Void Mirror.
Yeah, ban Void Mirror.
I don't want him to ban Delver.
Oh my gosh. Dude, the amount of people who are like, you should play this in Lavinia really hurt my brain.
You don't name Pod.
Yeah, we know that's there. And don't we see all the cards that come off Selvala?
Okay.
No. Oh, do you? Maybe. Yeah probably.
Okay. So yeah. We've got Birthing Pod, Concordant Crossroads. Okay.
What else did he have?
Two lands.
Okay.
Trying to play to not die and attempt to win, but I don't know if that's possible.
Damnation.
He's so dead.
You can what?
Cast Damnation.
Okay.
The game would end.
That is a true statement.
Actually, that's not even true. He just like picks up Jiraga's Tree Speaker, replays Selvala.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're screwed.
Yeah, I don't think there's literally a world where I can win. I literally have Enter the Infinite in my hand now. Like, I just...
You want to stop the Mirancy line next turn, right?
I'm just going to see what's in my top four, because...
Aven Mindsense is the greatest magic card I've printed?
Yeah. Yeah, that is...
It did stop my kill.
This Aven Mind Sensor has been seriously fucked the entire game, and it came down turn two, right? Like, it's just...
Yeah. Oh!
It's just been here the whole time.
Oh, did we hit? Hello.
What have we you hit? Something?
Oh!
Uh-oh.
That's a...
Phantasmal Image?
Yes!
Yeah!
Hoof, there it is.
Oh, just get hoofed right back?
Oh, no.
You can untap two blockers. Wait.
Looking in the top...
I have blockers.
Dude, you're so dead.
Nah, I can survive this.
I guess you're at 54.
Yeah, 54 life. Oh, that was insane.
That is mad. That is actually mad.
No, you're just hilarious. Actually dead, right? 8, 15, 22, 37. No,
this is my Hail Mary.
You cannot block and you cannot block and still stay alive.
You can he can untap his own hoof and block and untap his hoof and kill it with the his image trigger.
Yeah.
Even
yeah.
if he just takes it, he has him dead on the crackback and this isn't lethal.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's what was it 18
37 26?
Yeah.
48 right now. He's at 54.
This is the best I got, guys.
All right. Die a legend. Just take it and crack him back. Just don't block him even though you can. You have an onboard free kill of his creature. Just ignore it.
No, no, no. I'm getting in there. I'm
all right,
there.
All right.
The worst.
It was a kind of sick Hail Mary. You like hit Phantasmal and Mr. Captain.
Yeah, I was like, I wonder what I can hit. And I was like, oh, hello.
So weirdly, here's a weird thing. Would have hitting Lavinia helped you survive?
It may have?
Because then I can't bounce anything, I can't make mana.
Yeah, that probably was the correct thing.
Because when you went image, it's like, oh my fucking god.
We gotta make the content, man!
But that was also pretty gas. Either way was gas, yeah, right? I thought I was, true. And then I didn't even realize the hoof. When you hit Phantasmal, I'm just like, oh fuck, Linvala turns off all my mana. And then you made the hoof, it's like, oh, I guess I'm dead anyway, and then I wasn't dead.
That's yeah. pretty
sweet. Yeah, just passively gaining life the entire game with your commander has turned out to be huge.
Surprisingly good.
Yeah, that was great.
What I draw? You know, I okay.
What did you draw?
Altar of Dementia.
Oh, that's pretty close to insane. That
fucking every combo yeah. piece.
But Vince has an extremely nice number of cards in his deck right now. You don't have enough.
Yep.
Oh, are you ready to win the last flip of the game? Come on, Tails never fails. Wait, oh fuck. Like, okay.
It would have been actually really sick if you had put him.
Oh, wait, I gained life. Do you have me dead on the crackback?
17? Oh, yeah.
Ooh, let's find out.
I forgot Timna has lifelink.
Yeah.
Okay, so I've got to go
14, 15, 16. He can do 16 when you're at 17.
No, I can do more than that.
Got to find one point somewhere.
So pay life, play a pod.
Yeah, I'm just going to yield because I don't have.
Yeah, there's a sphere of resistance in play.
Yeah, it's like I
have
nothing. Oh
shit, I don't have a 2-drop to get mirror entity with.
Uh-oh.
That's fucking wild.
I mean,
I was like,
you can pick up a creature with symbiote and then survival it and just get mirror entity.
Yeah. Oh shit, thanks for the line, Bosh. That's pretty sweet.
Yeah.
You're
working too hard with that birthing pod.
Yeah, yeah, 100%. I want to make some mana then.
Okay.
Oh, Selvala just found a creature for you to pod or survive with too. Easy money.
Yeah. I keep thinking it's gonna generate me 3 mana and I keep forgetting we're not in a multiplayer game anymore. but I don't have the mana though, do I? Because now I go mirror entity for 3.
Yeah, you spent... just hadn't played the birthing pod, you wouldn't
yeah, spending
shoot.
4 for the
yeah, pod. Yeah, 100%. The pod has fucked me again. Oh god. Trying to be too cute.
We're still playing this game.
Oh no, I didn't click survival, I cast it! No! Okay, it's fine.
A disaster.
It's fine. It's fine. Fucking hell.
And you're even killing the one he wasn't untapping too. Why?
Wait, the game up.
That was the one point. The mana crypt was
the
one
point.
The
mana crypt was the one point.
Oh fuck.
No, he could untap it. That one was real.
Okay, so we're gonna make double green here. We're going to untap the Jiraga Tree Speaker, putting the Boreal Druid back in hand. Because the Druid is shit.
Yeah, casting Druid was just a smooth little storm line.
Just incredibly.
Storm line.
Yeah.
And then we're going to return a forest.
It was on purpose, guys.
Actually, we're going to go search him first. I'm going to click the survival this time, not the fucking Boreal Druid.
Good call.
Jesus Christ. Because I fucked around so much. Bear in mind, for people watching at home, by the way, it's 10:45 at night. I need to pee, and I'm very sweaty. I'm going to grab my mirror entity, but I don't think it does anything here because I have the mana this time around now. Because I go white, because it actually shrinks my creature if I don't get high enough, right?
But it grows so, everything else. Does it average out to a win?
I think. Say again, sorry?
Oh, okay. So here's the line.
3-3.
You have 3 mana in play right now, and then you can... Oh, wait, nope. You can bounce. You still have symbiote. No, you use symbiote on Boreal Druid.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
All right, so 3, 6, 9, 12, 13.
Can you use Quirin Ranger?
I got Quarry Mage alive.
Mirror Entity for 3 attacks for 19, right?
3, 6, 9, 12. 6, 7. 7 times
3
is
21.
Oh, we got it.
Yeah.
Magic is hard. Magic is hard. I'm going to untap the Jiraga Tree Speaker.
It's 22 with Skull Clan.
Hold on, though. I do have crypt. It's fine. I'm just gonna do it, and if I die, I fucked about so much.
Yeah.
And you untap Draga? Oh, you had Query. Yeah. Oh, then they're just make everything 5/5s and swing.
Yeah, that works too. It's all good.
Yeah.
That math does work.
You're all doing this math way quicker than me.
Well, just activate Mirror Entity for 5 and swing with the other 5 creatures. And
see, but that's why they're professional, like, successful pro tour players, and we're not.
I mean, it's also the middle of the day where we are, and
that's also true.
We didn't mention it earlier, but Pleasant Kenobi did get his second vaccine shot today, and he was already sick, so he came in below average.
So I've just got my. I'm just gonna make more and more excuses. This has got to be lethal, right? I should have done.
No, you're.
It was more mana to activate the Draga, but it's lethal either way.
That's why is it
lethal,
making me go to declare blockers? I can't declare blockers.
Because you never know. Welcome yeah, so I'm sat in this room. I've closed the window to, like, because I've just got an air filter because my hay fever is so severe that
there
I've had such bad colds. So I've just closed the doors. I've got this air filter on, but the temperature in my room must be above like 20 odd degrees right now, and it's like 11 o'clock at night, and there's no aircon in England. As a heads up for other people not understanding this. Yeah, fun game. I just derped about, pretended I had removal, didn't, and then got to win off of just derping some more, really.
Yeah, I mean, this was a nice little politic game of, like, Zach came out blazing, and I got pretty lucky to just barely survive protect the table for a turn, and then just the threats just kept changing, and it was secretly just PK there the whole time, just drawing cards and amassing resources with Selvala, and when the
It was the mind sensor.
I will say, had you not Gilded Draked the
the rector
academy rector, I had the win on turn 3.
Oh yeah, no shit, that's why I did it. Get the fuck out of here. All right,
interaction's good.
Everyone, thanks for watching. If you stuck out that hour and 46 minute game, you're a hero, and I hope you had fun, because that came down to some exciting stuff. Thank you all my guests for being here, and that's today's CDH pod.